Call that a Capriotti's Craving. And we've got you covered. Visit Capriotti's.com for locations, menus, and to order online. That's Capriotti's.com for the location on your way home. Or just swing by the Capriotti's location in the Newark Shopping Center and get your sub on.
As Delaware's first and only 24-7 urgent care center, Newark Urgent Care has served the greater Newark and University community since 1973. When you need to see a doctor and don't have time for appointments, Newark Urgent Care staff will see you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and are located at 324 East Main Street. Visit them at newarkurgentcare.org. At Newark Urgent Care, they deliver quick, convenient, and effective care on your schedule, and they never close.
You are listening to 94.7 WDSD, celebrating 20 seasons as the home for Blue Hens football.
Welcome back into Delaware Stadium. And Delaware, a break to start. There was a safety caught on the field, reversed to a touchback, and then Delaware goes 75 yards on six plays, taking 2:42 off the clock. A 38-yard touchdown run by Dejon Lee. 50 of Delaware yards on the drive coming from the feet of Dejon Lee. Corey Nido was down on the sideline right in front of what was a big celebration.
Thanks, Scott. You talk about a big momentum swing. That kickoff and then the touchdown by Lee, a beautiful jolt to the near side, and after Lee scored the end zone, he was able to get to the sideline. He was hoisted up by his offensive linemen. They love the 5'8" running back with the punch and the speed that he delivers. A fantastic start for this Blue Hens offense, Scott.
Thank you, Gordon. He's so shifty, is Dejon Lee. Just a different perspective when you go from having to defend Kenai Kane and Dejon Lee. A great 1-2 punch this season.
And that run there exemplifies exactly what you're talking about. He started right towards the imbalance, realized it was closed off, immediately jump cuts back to his left to the short side of the field, finds that little seam. There are not a lot of runners that can do that quickly and that seamlessly without losing any forward momentum. And Dejon Lee really showed us his great running style on that effort.
Kickoff is a short one, high to Forbes, who takes it to 15, gets to the 25-yard line before contact. Adewusi in on the tackle. Was able to talk with Tenny Adewusi earlier in the week at the coach's show and just complimented him on his intensity. He always comes and brings the energy for this football team. Tenny, 30 tackles on the season, getting his 31st of his senior campaign.
Well, he's had an excellent year out there at the cover corner. Nick Rapone speaks volumes of him, the cornerback coach, and he's had an excellent season. I like his length. He gets his arms on people. A very physical defender out in space.
12-12 on the first quarter clock. First possession for Zach Bednarczyk and the Villanova offense as they trail 7-0 to start. They'll begin at their own 28-yard line. And Bednarczyk will throw the football after the play fake, and the ball is dropped by Changa Hodge at the 35-yard line.
There's an awful lot of creativity to this Villanova offense. They'll use multiple sub-packages, multiple formations. Bednarczyk really does a nice job of coordinating all that. He's such a veteran, as we mentioned. And we'll see a lot of RPOs and play-action passes off of run fakes.
Single back this time to the left of Bednarczyk is Forbes. And Forbes will get his first carry running to the right side. And he bounces off of Troy Reeder, picking up a good carry of about 8 yards before he's pushed down by Casey Hinton.
Nice block there on a little gut block, meaning the left guard, Paul Gradden, who's their typical center, moves up on a little bit of a U block. Gets a nice hit initially to free off Forbes, who's very physical at the point of attack. Actually shed Troy Reeder there, one of the best tacklers in the FCS.
Troy Reeder, ninth in FCS football, as you mentioned, Bill. 10.7 tackles per game. Couldn't get him that time as Forbes slipped past, but now it's second down and three, and there's a flag.
Substitution violation, 12 men in the formation on Villanova. It's a 5-yard penalty, third down.
That's huge. It was going to be third down and three, and then Villanova with the penalty, making it more difficult for themselves. Moving back 5 yards, third down and eight, as Matt Goodzik will come in as the running back.
Goodzik, a very versatile performer for Villanova. He can run the ball, but he's very good out of the backfield and also excellent in pass pro.
And a shotgun, man in motion. Right to left. Here's Bednarczyk dropping back. Here comes. Oh, there's a flag on the play. Kitchen was all over that one, but there was a flag.
Right on the ball being snapped. False start. 67 on the offense. 5-yard penalty. It is still third down.
That's MJ Dumas. MJ Dumas is the only player on the offensive line that's in his original spot at right guard.
Well, he got, I won't say intimidated, but he got spooked there by Cam Kitchen, who almost raised up before he rushed, got him out of his stance. And Kitchen is so tough and very quick off the ball. He's just gotten so much healthier than he was earlier on in the season. Got great legs, providing a big push up the middle.
Here's third and 13. Bednarczyk passes caught at the 28 to the 30. It's Bell. He cannot stretch the football further enough. He got stopped at the 34-yard line, 5 yards shy of the first down marker, and Delaware gets a stop. It would have been third down and three. Back-to-back penalties made it third and 13. And now fourth and five. We'll see the punt unit.
Excellent rally to the football by the entire Delaware defense, especially Nashir Adderley coming down from the safety position to kind of finalize the tackle. An excellent job there of running to the football, something Delaware works on so hard in practice.
Adderley and Papali back, and a timeout taken by Delaware as we were calling for a punt, and Villanova did not have a punter out there. Delaware not ready for it as Papali and Adderley were back. They call a timeout. We'll stay right here as Forbes was lined up to take the direct snap.
Now, I haven't seen that formation before, but my guess is Forbes can probably pooch kick it. But that forced Delaware intelligently into taking a timeout, something they haven't seen before. Villanova obviously can try a lot of different stuff here this afternoon. I mentioned how their offensive staff, in particular the offensive coordinator, Sam Venuto, is very clever. He's been around a long time, a very savvy veteran who really does a lot formationally, has made up with different personnel packages due to so many injuries for Villanova's offense.
So likely the only damage that comes from that is going to be Delaware using a first half timeout, as they'll bring the punt unit out now as Nathan Fondacaro. 47 punts on the year. He's good. 41.7 on average. Vinny Papali will be back to return. Vinny, 13 punt returns on the year, averaging 3.5 yards per return, a long of 12 yards. Fondacaro gets it off. It's a low kick to Papali. He'll take it at the 36-yard line. He'll be 31-yard line. He'll be brought down there. And Delaware will be back out on offense for the second time today when we come back. 10:29 left in the first quarter of action. Delaware 7, Villanova yet to score.
Concord Pet Food and Supplies with 29 locations. There's bound to be one near you. Visit Concord Pet Food and Supplies today or shop online at ConcordPetFoods.com.
Just For You is taking over for My Mix at Acme, and it's making saving even easier. You'll find more ways to redeem rewards for savings on gas or groceries. Just For You, available on the Acme app. Genio or Signature Farms Grade A basted frozen turkeys are only 39 cents a pound. Limit one. And 8-inch bakery pies in your choice of pumpkin, harvest or Dutch apple, or coconut custard are just $3.99 each. Restrictions and exclusions apply. For complete details, go to acmemarkets.com/rewards.
Mix it up and order any two or more Domino's medium two-topping pizzas, specialty chicken, stuffed cheesy breads, bread twists, or marble cookie brownie for $5.99 each.
The Office of Charles Wallace has insurance that's right for you. Home, auto, renters, and motorcycle. Big enough to serve you, small enough to know you. CharlesWallaceInsurance.net.
Delaware football is on 94.7 WDSD FM and iHeartRadio.
Welcome back into Delaware Stadium, where the Hens lead 7-0, 10:29, first quarter of action. It is packed here at Delaware Stadium. All the fans in town, they know what this game means. It's a rivalry game. It also means a chance to punch your ticket into the playoffs if you're Delaware and get that 8th win. Hey, I want to remind our listeners that for over 40 years, Brandywine Electronics has been a reliable asset to the Delaware Valley audiovisual community. They're always helping us out. I was here last night setting up equipment, had a question, called Joe for Brandywine Electronics, got on FaceTime, showed the box and showed some of the setup, and he was helping me out. Always there to help, always there to improve, and we love working with Brandywine Electronics. Visit BEL.com for all your audio needs. Delaware on the field to start this drive, first and 10 from their own 30-yard line. And it's the man that ran for 50 yards on that first drive, Dejon Lee. He gets two more. It'll be second down and 8.
Well, it's clear the early strategy, especially against the wind, has come out and run Lee behind our big front. Villanova uses a 3-3-5, meaning they have extra defensive back in the game almost all the time, a good defense to run against.
There's movement on that defensive line. He knew it. He jumped Brian White, the senior. 35th consecutive start. There was movement. I believe he jumped before anyone moved from Delaware. We'll hear the call from the referee, Jeff Bray.
offside with contact. Number 90 on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
That's already the fourth penalty of the game for Villanova.
I was going to remark, Villanova well penalized throughout the season. That's part of why they're 4-6. That big 15-yard face mask penalty got Delaware some great field position early on in the drive to initiate the first touchdown.
Single back is Dejon Lee. They'll go to him again. Look
at the end of the wind to be able to run the ball and dominate the time of possession.
There is a strong wind against Delaware. You're right, out of shotgun form. It's Pacquiao, first and 10. Ball at the Villanova 47 as Papali goes in motion from left to right. Keogh turns, gives again to Dejon Lee, trying to bounce the outside. Villanova there that time. Tackle for loss back in Delaware territory at the 49. Going to be lost of about 4 yards as Delaware leads 7-0 in the clock at 9:05 first quarter.
Delaware continuing to utilize the unbalanced set with a little bit different window dressing with the motion, and that play was strung out well by the left side, especially Drew Wiley, the linebacker, did a nice job of coming upfield and setting the edge.
Second down and 14, Pat Kehoe approaching the line and looking over to the sideline to get the call. Delaware still has 11 seconds to get the play off as it ticks down under 10 now. Back in formation is Pat Kehoe out of shotgun form on second and 14. The lefty will go to throw, tosses one towards Delaware sideline. Walker slipped for a moment, got back up on his feet, but could not come down with the catch as he got the ball in his hands, but a pass breakup by Nuola Iwopeitu, the reserve cornerback.
Throwing a deep out to the wide side of the field. A wonderful throw by Kehoe. In on time, in rhythm, good protection, but just a better defensive play. The cornerback, Iwopeitu, drove on that extremely well. Joe actually had separation, but I think it was the length of the throw that allowed the Villanova defender to recover.
Came across the field, balls on the far side, hash through a near side to us. 8:30 first quarter, third and 14 for Delaware. From their own 49-yard line, throwing down Kehoe. Does so to Scarf at the 40, needed 3 more yards, brought down by Keeling Hunter. And Delaware will likely stay on the field here. It's kind of that mid-range, can't kick a field goal, don't want to punt. We'll see if they go for it. Now they're going to bring the punt unit on, and it looked like Pat Kehoe was at least motioning that he wouldn't mind staying on the field there.
Boy, that was a terrific throw, a great route run by Charles Scarf. He just was forced short because of where the defense was aligned by 2 yards, but an excellent pattern, a little turn in, perfectly delivered by Kehoe. I like the rhythm that Pat Kehoe has early on with his receivers.
He is looking good, 12 yards there. They needed 14 though. And now Nick Pritchard will try to back up Villanova. This one high. And it's going to be fair caught at the 6-yard line. For Nick Pritchard, that is his 16th kick inside the 20 on the season. He's been phenomenal all year long, and maybe that's why you punt it, because you trust your defense and you're going to back up Villanova. We'll take a timeout with 7:53 remaining in the first quarter, and Delaware up 7-0. Hey, it's Scott Klatskin, voice of the Blue Hens, and when my family needed to purchase a new vehicle, we chose Chevrolet of Dover. The Chevy Equinox has everything we need, from style and technology to performance and safety. This versatile crossover offers us the complete package. But even more so, Chevrolet of Dover offered the complete package. From the time I walked through the door, owner Matt made me feel comfortable and helped me find the right vehicle for my family. Do what I did and visit ChevroletofDover.com. Chevrolet of Dover. Find new roads.
The Barnes & Noble UD Bookstore is the official bookstore of the University of Delaware. It's your place for all the official Blue Hens and Adidas sideline gear. Open 7 days a week and located on Main Street in Newark, the Barnes & Noble UD...
Oh, say can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get 6 numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big.
Risk win. I think it was an excellent decision and well executed by the punt team. And now the defense will get a chance to work against Villanova's offense, trying to come out from a very difficult position. In their first drive, they were clearly out of sync with penalties.
Villanova just 16 total yards of offense, 86 for Delaware, including an opening drive that went 75 yards. Bednarczyk comes out in shotgun form, and Aaron Forbes is the running back. Forbes will get the carry to the right side, and Troy Reeder was there amongst others at the 9-yard line. Stood up, he'll give him to the 10. Cam Kitchen, amongst other defensive linemen in the mix as well. A pickup of 3. It'll be second down and 7.
Well, Troy Reeder shows why he's so good. Armin Ware getting in his first plays of the game at left defensive end. Did a great job there of taking on 2 blockers, allowed Troy Reeder to work downhill and make another tackle, just adding to his terrific record.
Troy Reeder, triple-digit tackles on the year. 107 coming in, leads the team in that category. Second down and 7 for Villanova. Backs to the left and right of Bednarczyk. They go to Forbes. Forbes has a hole, but it closed quickly thanks to Charles Bell. What a tackle in space. Coming over for help was Tenny Adewusi. And a 3-yard pickup by Forbes. That could have been 30 had Bell not tracked him down.
We talk so much about Troy Reeder and sometimes Kobe Reeder, but how about Charles Bell? Great side-to-side lateral mobility there. Makes a terrific tackle working left to right. Much more difficult than you think, especially when your angle is cut down and you've got to tackle a runner like Forbes, who has great leverage.
70th tackle on the year for Charles Bell, who's out there pointing directions to his teammates on 3rd down and 4. Villanova 13-yard line. Bednarczyk will keep throwing down the field. It's caught at the 40, 45 midfield. It's a foot race. 40, 30, at the 20, 15, 10. A touchdown saving tackle by Casey Hinton. Jarrett McClendon almost got all of it. But a huge gain for Villanova makes it first and goal to go.
Well, the play action felt fake, held the linebackers, allowed that second level to open up. McClendon has excellent speed, but a terrific play by Casey Hinton coming all the way across the field to save it. And that's something that these Delaware defensive coaches preach, is getting the last player across to make the game-saving tackle. In many cases, you never know what happens.
And a whistle before the snap. As a timeout taken by Villanova, we'll stay right here. This all important for Villanova. They only get points on the board, and not just a touchdown, points at all in the red zone on 65% of their chances. There's 124 teams in FCS football. That ranks Villanova 117th in the country, so they've had difficulties in the red zone. It's first and goal to go from the 6 after what was an 81-yard officially pass from Bednarczyk to McClendon. Of course, the pass went 4 yards. McClendon did the rest.
Well, that's what I talked about when I made the comment, game saving, because you never know that it might be. It was a touchdown saving, clearly, but those plays are ones that defensive coaches talk about. That's how you save the game, and you just never know the emphasis, especially, as you mentioned, with the difficulty Villanova's had of scoring in the red zone. A big win here would be to only give up 3.
Villanova only 23 yards total prior to that pass of 81 yards. Forbes running back on first and goal to go from the 6-yard line. 6 minutes left in the first quarter. They sent a man in motion. Bednarczyk keeps it, goes up the middle, trying to spin into the end zone, and he does. It's a touchdown for Bednarczyk. He was hit at the 1 and was able to reach the football over the goal line for a score, and it's 7-6, Blue Hens.
They fake speed sweep to field. Bednarczyk then reads it and pulls the ball, and then they do a little scoop block with the right guard, MJ Dumas. Did a nice job there at the point of attack, and Bednarczyk is really tough. He lowered his shoulder. This is a player that's been injured, fighting back from that, but the senior did an excellent job there of locating the end zone.
And we mentioned Villanova's troubles in the red zone this season. A different team, obviously, when Zach Bednarczyk is out there, not just for his throwing ability, but from what we saw right there. Able to run that RPO, make the right decision, keep it himself, and score up the gut of that Delaware defense. On for the extra point will be Drew Kresge. He's 25 of 28 this year on PATs. A chance to tie this score. Kick is up and through for Villanova. 7-7 is the count with 5:54 remaining in this first quarter of football, and we'll stay right here. There's a reason we keep going back to Unique Impressions on Main Street for all our apparel and embroidery needs. The quality and customer care are unmatched. All their work is professionally done right on site. Location cannot be any more convenient, right on East Main Street in Newark. For 30 years, Unique Impressions has been providing businesses and organizations with personal attention and ideas needed to create amazing Finished Products. It's a great time to get your holiday gifts. Let them make an impression on you. Unique Impressions Shop, uniqueimpressions.com. So Delaware had Villanova backed up inside of their own 15-yard line. It was a third down play. Ben Narzik goes 81 yards to Jarrett McClendon. One play later, it's a tie score, 7-0.
Well, the play fake was really the essential key to the success of that play for Villanova. Ben Narzik really does a nice job with his ball handling and play faking. Allows him a little bit more time to set up and then to locate his favorite wide receiver, Jarrett McClendon, who did a nice job running after the catch.
Nathan Fondacaro will kick this one away. The first kick of the day, almost a safety for Delaware. This time, Fondacaro makes it unreturnable. It bounces out of the end zone and a touchback for Delaware. The offense back on the field, 5:54. First quarter action here at Delaware Stadium. Score 7-7. This will be the third possession for Delaware offensively.
Well, I've liked the early strategy, mixing up formations, using the unbalanced set. A lot of Dejon Lee, but also good protection so far by Delaware's front from Pat Kehoe.
And we still have not seen Kenai Kane. He was banged up after the Stony Brook game, from everything we were told, available in this contest. But we'll see Dejon Lee, who's having a good day. 7 carries for 64 yards back out there on the field for this Delaware offense. 1st and 10 from their own 25-yard line. And Kehoe going to drop back to throw. Ball slips out of his hands, and it's intercepted at the 21-yard line. It was Jafonta Johnson, the defensive end, who stepped in and made the catch. The ball just slipped right out of his hands, went about 3 feet in the air. The defensive end able to get the INT, a turnover for Delaware. That's the 16th interception of the year for the Villanova defense.
Well, that's clearly what happened. Sometimes with less moisture in your fingers and against the wind, the ball just slipped out. There was nothing he could do there as his arm moved forward. There was a blitz. It was well picked up, and unfortunately for Delaware, just a bad luck, and that's going to happen from time to time. The ball just slips out of the quarterback's hands.
A miscue for Delaware, a couple miscues. The first play of the game was a kickoff to Nasir Adderley. He tipped out of the end zone and brought it back in. It was a safety originally called. When they looked at it again, decided it was a touchback, and now on Delaware's third possession, the ball just slipped right out of Pat Kehoe's hands, went up in the air, and came down in Jafonta Johnson's hands for a turnover. Villanova's offense on the field, 1st and 10. From their own 23, or from Delaware's 23. Benarzik looking for the end zone. Bell dropped the pass. It was a bit high, but catchable. Casey Hinton in coverage. And you don't see that much from Ryan Bell. That was a securable touchdown toss, but the drop makes it 2nd and 10 for the 23.
Bell running a post from the right side into the middle of the field. Benarzik uses a little fake toss to the left that bought him some time. He was able to survey the scene, delivers an excellent pass, but Bell just maybe like Kehoe having a little trouble with his grip.
Forbes back in as the running back to the right, Covington to the left of Bednarczyk, and Forbes has it in a big hole on the left side, turns the corner, stiff arm, first down to the 10. Bell pushes him down. It's going to be 1st and goal to go from the 9-yard line. Just moments ago, it was 1st and goal to go from the 6 for Villanova. They scored on the next play. Now they'll have it 1st and goal to go, 9 yards out.
Running a little sweep to the left. Bell and rifle to the right of Bednarczyk. Just gets an early step. The edge was sealed. Bell with a very fine tackle coming from the opposite side of the field. Looks very active here this afternoon.
Tie score 7-all, 5:17 first quarter. Bednarczyk on the RPO, running wide. It's Covington trying to turn. coming up for Villanova. Delaware moved, got back behind the line. Snap comes, and the kick is up and through. It is now 14-7. A quick turn of events here at Delaware Stadium, as Delaware is up 7-0, looking good. Had a third down situation for Villanova. Villanova goes 81 yards, as I just mentioned. First and goal to go from the six. Bednarczyk punches it in. Delaware gets the football back. First play, an interception. And four plays later, Delaware is down 14-7. A lot of action here still in the first quarter. A lot of football left. But right now, this crowd a little quieter than it was to begin this game.
Well, Villanova taking advantage of, I would call it a stroke of good luck. Very rarely does that happen with a quarterback in perfect position. He was actually well protected, and he's delivering it to a wide open receiver. The ball just slipped out as he was moving it forward. So I'm sure that Pat Kehoe will make doubly sure that this next time when he's throwing that he has enough moisture on his hands. But let's not forget, these can be difficult situations to throw in only because he's not using a glove. A few quarterbacks do in this. It's windy again like last week, and there is almost no moisture in the air to keep his fingers flexible and soft.
Vonnecaro back out to kick this one away. 24 touchbacks on the season. About 50% of his kicks are not returned. This one will be returnable, as Adderley will take it from the three. At the 5-10-yard line, sprints to the 20-yard line and gets to the 25 before first contact. Down he goes at the 26. So fast out there with the football in his hands is Nasir Adderley. Trajan Anderson brought him down. And Delaware, right about the area where that interception occurred on the first play last drive, will come back out on offense. And I believe I see Kenai Kane in the huddle at least, possibly coming out for the first time. And now Kenai Kane going to go towards the sideline. And Nolan Henderson is in, along with Andre Robinson. So Nolan Henderson, the quarterback right now, we'll try to get an update on as to why Nolan Henderson in the game, and not Pat Kehoe, and Andre Robinson in as well on first and 10. The Smyrna product turns, gives to Robinson. There's a flag on the play as Robinson gets to the 29-yard line. There is a flag, and Henderson's staying in. As I try to peek down on the sideline and try to find where Pat Kehoe might be. We'll try to get an update for you.
Defense. Number
a break
29,
for Delaware.
Lined up in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty. We'll repeat first down.
Another penalty for Villanova. So Delaware down 14-7, and Nolan Henderson playing his first football of his career. He's got into one game, just take a knee, I believe. He hasn't thrown any passes. Nolan Henderson, local product, former Gatorade Player of the Year from Smyrna High School, in the game out of shotgun form, and his running back is Andre Robinson. Robinson gets the give, and he is brought down right away for a loss by Keeling Hunter. It'll be second down and 5. This is worrisome for Delaware fans right now. We have no information as we go under 4 minutes in the first quarter, and Delaware has its second down and 7.
Well, with this young quarterback in the game, Villanova stacking the box as you would expect. Hunter coming down from a cornerback position, working off the edge. Nolan Henderson, though, has a lot of game. I'm very hopeful of this young man. I watched him and called a number of games when he was at Smyrna. An excellent player, a clutch performer, and he can deliver the ball on target.
He's going to scramble. He can also run with the football. Gets to the 34-yard line. Brought down by Rob Roll, one of the captains of this team. It's going to be third down and short for Delaware with 3:17.
What always impressed me about Nolan Henderson was his ability to run the ball. He was known as a thrower in that dynamic, widespread offense that Smyrna utilized. But he was an excellent runner, not only to roll out, but also on the belly read. Even though he had Will Knight giving the ball off too many times, he could get himself out on the perimeter.
Heck of a moment for Nolan Henderson to make his debut. Third down and 2. Give it to Robinson. He's not going to get it. Not going to get close. Delaware stuffed. Malik Fisher was there at the line of scrimmage. And a 3-and-out for the Blue Hens, playing on this drive without Dejon Lee, Kenai Kane, or Pat Kehoe. And we'll try to get more information as it becomes available. But Delaware down 14-7 with 2:33 and ticking, going to come out to punt the football.
And unfortunately, even though Pritchard is a terrific punter, he is kicking into a fairly brisk wind, so this could possibly give Villanova some decent field position here.
Nick Pritchard barely got that one away, as Covington might have even got a hand on it, as it skips to the 40 and down at the 35-yard line in Nova territory. Defense coming back onto the field, needing a stop as we try to get any word on what's going on with the offense and the available players. First and 10 from the 34 for Villanova coming up. And as Delaware tries to get healthy, seemingly offensively, the defense needs to stop the bleeding.
Well, Pritchard did a great job there. Nick realized the snap was a little off. He rolls quickly, almost rugby style, to his right to avoid that inside pressure that Villanova was putting on. So a savvy play there by the punter, Nick Pritchard, to get any sort of field position down the field. That ball could have easily been blocked.
And Coach Rocco, throughout the season, has said the backup quarterback position has switched throughout the year as J.P. Caruso has some grad classes, sometimes not able to get to practice. So sometimes it's Caruso, sometimes it's Henderson. Bednarczyk on first down, going all the way down the field for Changa Hodge. It's incomplete, possibly. Could have made the argument for a penalty as there was some contact. Mark Ferrante is certainly making that argument as he raced down the field to talk with the referee, but an incomplete pass sailed over the head of Changa Hodge. It was at the Delaware 30-yard, at the Villanova 30-yard line.
Villanova is a quick strike team. They love to take advantage of these situations at what I call sudden change. Bednarczyk did a great job there against the three-man pressure of buying time, and then underthrew Hodge, who ran a post pattern from left to right.
Tight trips to the right side on second down. Forbes going to run that way, has a hole at the 40. 42-yard line. Tenney had a Woosie, a nice tackle in space. 1 yard shy of the first down marker. It's going to be third down and a yard for Villanova.
That play was set up by the converted left tackle to right tackle because of injuries. Ethan Greenridge did a terrific job there of getting out in front and getting that massive 6'4", 345-pound body on the Delaware defender that was trying to set the edge.
See if Delaware get a stop as we approach 90 seconds left in the first quarter. Delaware went up 7-0. Now they trail 14-7. Villanova 1 of 2 on third down today. A quick snap to the fullback, and he gets enough for the first down, a little bit more. As it was actually Forbes who went up the middle to get the first down. So 2 of 3 on third down for Villanova. And the drive continues. As, I think I'm still maybe stunned at what we saw offensively. And Delaware and the fans, I think, probably is shocked as well to see Nolan Henderson come out and no sign of Pat Kehoe since the interception he threw. And now defense has got to stay out on the field and try to get off the field. But a first down conversion for Villanova to go under a minute here in the first quarter. And the Wildcats up 14-7. Bednarczyk, plenty of time to throw. In the flat, it's going to be Forbes running at the 45 of Delaware to the 40. First down, 35 at the 30. 25-yard line and inside the 25. Tackled by Nasir Adderley, but another huge gain for Villanova as they get close to the red zone.
And Villanova will probably go faster, only to continue to utilize the wind. I was a little surprised he let so much time run off. That was just a little swing route, nothing open down the field. They get the ball to Forbes in space. He's able to avoid the Delaware tackler and get a huge gain.
Forbes has been a Delaware killer in his career. A 30-yard gain for Delaware. And now Villanova has it first and 10 from the 23-yard line of the Hens. Bednarczyk operating out of shotgun. And I think they wanted to snap the football, but they did get it off to end the first quarter of action. At least that seems to be what the whistle was for. Yeah, they snapped the football, but it was at zero. I don't know if they were trying to get one more play or not, but in any case, they'll take possession of the football into the second quarter with a 14-7 lead in a good position to add to their lead here at Delaware Stadium. The Hens need to make a stop when we come back on 94.7 WDSD.
IBEW Local 313 features the most skilled and productive electricians in the area. Visit IBEW313.org to find contractors who will provide you with the unsurpassed electrical service you deserve.
At Dash Inn, you can get any size coffee or cappuccino for only 99 cents. Yep, any size coffee or cappuccino for just 99 cents. Made with 100% Arabica beans, our coffees are bold, smooth, and rich. And for a limited time, we have pumpkin spice cappuccino, a seasonal favorite. Fall in love at first sip with Dash Inn coffee. Any size for only 99 cents. Just 99 cents. Find a location near you at dashinn.com. That is dashinn.com.
Star Health at the University of Delaware.
Got a great Black Friday deal. One for you, one for me.
Aw, I love it. I got us a little something too.
Yeah?
Yep. One for you,
and one for me.
I love it.
Oh, actually, that was supposed to be for me.
I love it.
And I love that you love
it. I love it.
I like red.
During the GMC Sierra Black Friday event, get over $12,000 total value on a specially equipped 2018 Sierra SLT Crew Cab when you finance through GM Financial.
So you guys have recently started dating?
Yes.
A little less than a month.
Coming up on 2 months now, yeah.
Cool. I want to show you guys these three Chevy SUVs. The first one is called the Trax.
Beautiful.
Do you think it would be good for moving in together?
Moving in together?
Okay. Well, this is the Chevy Equinox.
Wow. Nice.
Perfect for when you two have your first kid.
Give me some time.
Okay. This is the Traverse for when you have your five kids, two dogs, and one cat.
Oh. Five?
Well, no matter what stage of life you're in, Chevy has an SUV for you.
We have it all planned out. Thanks.
Hot start for Delaware. They marched down the field. A 38-yard touchdown run by Dejon Lee made it 7-0. But it has changed quickly at the tail end of that first quarter, where Villanova got a big chunk play of 81 yards, scored on the next play, then took advantage of an interception in a short field to go up 14-7. And then as we went back out on offense, Nolan Henderson out, nowhere to be found is Pat Kehoe right now. So Delaware right now down and trying to figure some things out. The fans certainly a little worry right now based on what we've seen as of late.
Well, the issue at hand is for our defense to dig in and not allow a touchdown here.
Covington has it. Colby Reeder digging in with a nice tackle from behind. Allowing a minimal gain to the 21-yard line, 2 yards.
Villanova taking a little page out of Delaware's offensive book by running the unbalanced into the boundary, but that time Delaware's defense shifted, and they'll see that a lot in practice. So sometimes using what another team uses isn't always a good idea because they see it so often in practice.
Second down and 8 coming up. New quarter of football, second quarter of action here, 14-7, Villanova leading. And Zach Van Narzik out of shotgun form. He has two wide receivers to the left, sends a man in motion. And he'll drop back, pump, pressure coming. And a man is open. It's Forbes at the 20-yard line. And Colby Reeder makes the stop, but not before Forbes runs to the first down marker and is pushed out of bounds. Another first down for the Wildcats.
Delaware brought Ray Jones, and this is something I really like. Delaware starting to blitz a little bit more in the red zone, trying to impact Benarczyk's decision-making. It was well picked up there, forced to go to the check down. A nice tackle by Colby Reeder in field on a very elusive runner.
Just got word from our sports information director, Scott Day, Pat Kehoe in concussion testing right now. So must have gotten a hit on an interception play the last time he was on the field. And we'll kind of try to keep an eye out to see what happens. Right now it's Forbes trying to bounce the outside. And Nasir Adderley might have saved a touchdown at the 14-yard line. He got him by the shoestrings. And it's going to be second down and 10, as there's no gain on that play.
Ray Jones off the edge again. A nice call by Chris Kosh. And then Adderley coming down just as the runner was slowed up. He had a perfect angle and makes a nice shoestring tackle.
Villanova checking with the sideline. 13-25, second quarter. Ray Jones trying to fire up his teammates out there on the field. Hens looking for a stop defensively. Already trailing by 7 early in this first half of football. Bednarczyk out of shotgun. He'll drop back to pass. Has some time. Pocket closing now, and he's being chased. Flushed out of the pocket by Brandon Hall. Bednarczyk throwing. End zone wide. Diving forward and incomplete. He was looking for Forbes. There is a flag thrown.
Flag on the play.
After the ball dropped incomplete. Officials getting together on the call. Having a discussion around the 10-yard line. Ball was thrown into the end zone. Forbes couldn't come up with it.
Ineligible downfield on the offense. Number 67, 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. We'll repeat second down.
That's the second penalty on MJ Dumas today, the right guard. And Villanova hurting themselves with penalty. That's the 6th penalty of the game. And now it's going to be second down and 15.
On the 18-yard line, second down and 15.
When you have a quarterback like Bednarczyk that can be so elusive, gets out on the edge. I actually thought he should have run the ball there, and I don't blame Dumas for being down the field, but a good job by the officiating staff to catch that. Many times they'll give, especially in the RPO type offenses, that offensive lineman about 2 yards.
Dumas with the penalty, 6 penalties, 40 yards so far for Villanova. Second and 15 from the 18-yard line in the red zone. It's Gudzik. Ball comes loose. Delaware picks it up. Malcolm Brown has the football at the 15, and Delaware gets the turnover.
Very alert on the cutback was Delaware's defense. Three tacklers. I'm not sure actually who made the tackle to dislodge it, but then Delaware very quickly picks the ball up, and a massive tackle there on the sideline saves Adderley from not going all the way.
I believe Colby Reeder knocked it loose. That's his second forced fumble of the season. He's already picked up two fumbles, and Delaware got the turnover that they needed. Something big to happen defensively as Villanova had scored touchdowns on back-to-back possessions. They are going to review the play. It was clearly a fumble. And Malcolm Brown with his second fumble recovery of the season. His first was a touchdown at North Dakota State. Let's see if that can't change the energy in this stadium and on the field for the Delaware Blue Hens. And we'll see who comes out of that huddle. And Corey, do you have an eye on the huddle down there on the field?
I do, Scott. Right now it does look like Nolan Henderson is going to come back out at quarterback for Delaware. He is right in the middle of the circle. And after the previous drive offensively for Delaware, everybody on the sideline saying, hey, we got this, Nolan, you got this. So certainly behind the young quarterback.
Giving some energy to Nolan Henderson if he has to be the quarterback the rest of the way. Thank you, Corey. And as I started to say to start the Villanova drive, Coach Rocco telling us even earlier in the season, the question arise not for this week necessarily, but who is your backup quarterback? Is it J.P. Caruso? Is it Nolan Henderson? And he was very honest. He said it changes week to week. J.P. Caruso is a graduate student here at Delaware, and sometimes his class schedule does not allow him to get to practice throughout the week. And, you know, Coach Rocco and him had a discussion, was okay with it. He's getting his degree, his master's here at the University of Delaware. And so because of that, Nolan Henderson sometimes is a backup quarterback. Darius Wade from Middletown, he's had a shoulder injury throughout the year, so really never got into the mix as a backup quarterback. So now you have essentially who we thought was the fourth-string quarterback in the spring, at least, coming in and being the backup quarterback, Nolan Henderson. Let's hear the call.
One of his neighbors down prior to the ball coming
out. Oh, no.
It'll be Villanova's ball at the 17-yard line. Second down. 17-yard line.
Wow. Delaware got a break to start the game when a safety was overturned. And now they're saying that the runner's knee was down before the ball popped loose. I did not think that was going to be overturned at all. Obviously, the referees are looking at it and seeing differently, but now a break for Villanova. I assume we're all set to see the offense back on the field. What it is, though, is a third down and 14 for the Wildcats. Forbes is the running back, trips to the right side for Nova. After the fumble recovery was overturned, Bednarczyk will operate out of shotgun. Throwing, end zone, looking for McClinton, overthrew his target out of the end zone. He was double teamed by Adderley and Malcolm Brown, solid coverage, and now the kicking team will come on. This is a kicker in Drew Kresge who has struggled this year. 6 of 13, that's just 46% of his field goals have gone through. And he is just 3 of 10 beyond 29 yards. This is going to be a 34-yard field goal.
Delaware overloads the left side and will bring pressure, and Villanova is countered with an unbalanced set to that side to stop this edge rush.
J.J. Scarpello will hold. Crabtree will snap it. It's blocked! Colby Reeder got his hand on it! Play, huge stop. Colby got the fumble forced. It was overturned, and now Colby with the block to keep the score 14-7, 12:31, second quarter. We'll take all that energy into a timeout, and when we come back, Delaware will operate on offense, a chance to tie it up. Back in a moment on 94.7 WDSD.
This is Dr. Michael Axe of First Aid Orthopedics, the team of top docs taking care of Delaware from the beach to the bridge and beyond. If you have shoulder or knee pain or a condition in another body region, please call us for an appointment at one of our 12 statewide locations. We treat muscle, tendon, and bone or joint ailments from your neck to your toes with the latest techniques to include PRP and stem cells. For more FSO information, go to our website, firstaidortho.com. You can also Twitter with our physicians and staff, but you should Facebook with us, especially on Patient Testimonial Tuesdays.
There was a pump fake on the media timeout. The red hat that decides on media timeouts without on the field, he decided to come back off the field, which threw off our timing. Thank you, Ronnie Vickers, for getting us back into action. A 7-yard pickup by Nolan Henderson as Delaware's offense back onto the field will make up for that timeout later on in this first quarter. And it's second down and 3. Henderson showing his legs thus far as the Hens operating left to right as we see it, heading towards that south end zone. Lee with the carry. Good to see he's okay as he didn't see the field on the last possession. It was Robinson who ran the football. 2-yard carry for Dejon Lee. Third down and 1 for the Hens here as Delaware went 3 and out last possession. A chance to continue the drive here. It's third down and 1. Nolan Henderson is the quarterback. Bryce DeMallet comes in as that tight end fullback position. Delaware needs a yard.
Well, I'm very comfortable with Nolan Henderson in the game. I've really liked his poise throughout the preseason practice. He's clearly in command of the offense.
Henderson under center. Gibb is to Dejon Lee. There's contact behind the line of scrimmage. And that's going to be a tackle for a loss by Julian Williams. It'll be fourth down and 1. And we see Nick Pritchard again. Delaware not able to do anything on offense right now with Pat Kehoe out of the game in concussion testing.
A little bit conservative, just trying to run the ball from an under, usually out of shotgun. Excellent penetration by the front three of Villanova there to kind of set the edge and force Lee back into tacklers.
The return man is Josh McGrigg as Nick Pritchard out to punt this one away after another 3 and out by a Delaware. Pritchard from the 10-yard line gets this one away. It's a good one. Spinning, backpedaling is McGrigg, taking it from the 26-yard line at the 30, 35, and he's brought down. Nigel Hill was there, I believe.
26, Josh McGrigg on the return.
And Eric Scogbo, I think, made the tackle defensively.
Also 26, Eric Scogbo.
So Delaware now will take that timeout, excuse me, as the timeout is on the field. So it's first and 10 for Villanova when we come back. 10:25 left in the second quarter. Wildcats up 14-7. We'll be back in a moment at 94.7 WDSD.
Lots of things take 15 minutes, like sitting through a halftime show or running a very slow mile. Well, Buffalo Wild Wings wants to add one more to the list, the B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch. Order from this menu and you'll get your lunch in 15 minutes or it's free. So put in your order, count all the tiles on our ceiling, and voila, 15 minutes and your food has arrived. Or it's on us. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Valid for tables of 6 or last Monday through Friday, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. at participating locations for dine-in only. Other restrictions apply. See participating location for details.
You've reached the voicemail of Aaron Rodgers.
Aaron, my man, it's your favorite sports agent, Gabe. Listen, I may have ever so slightly dinged your side mirror pulling out of your driveway. Give me a shout. Bad news, your side mirror is broken. Good news, the other dents are so bad you won't even notice the mirror. Ciao.
Hey, Aaron, Patrick with State Farm here. Sounds like we have ourselves another Gabe situation. No worries, though. State Farm's got you covered.
For agents who are there for you, go with the one that's here to help life go right. State Farm.
You're listening to 94.7 WDSD, celebrating 20 seasons as the home for Blue Hens football.
Welcome back to Delaware Stadium, where the Hens trail 14-7 in this battle of the blue, and a lot going on in this football game. Not much going on offensively over the last two possessions. Delaware 3 and out twice. Let's head down to the sideline and Corey Nido for more.
Thanks, Scott. Well, Mario Farinella and Nolan Henderson working on snap exchanges on the sideline. Starting quarterback Pat Kehoe is back on the sideline, but with his helmet off, as you mentioned, in that concussion protocol. So right now it does look like Nolan Henderson will be the quarterback moving forward in this game for the time being, Scott.
Thank you so much, Corey. And I can see now eyes on Pat Kehoe. He is on the sideline and helmet off. Right now Delaware, who got a stop defensively thanks to a Colby Reeder blocked field goal, back on the field. As is Zach Bednarczyk out of shotgun form, as this drive will start first and 10 for Villanova at their own 34-yard line. Bednarczyk stepping up to throw, and Forbes dropped a touchdown pass. Bednarczyk, excuse me, it was Adeyemi Da Silva, a wide receiver who was lined up at quarterback. He walked towards the line of scrimmage and tossed. It's kind of a play you saw Tim Tebow with a jump pass in Florida. And he led Aaron Forbes, who was ahead of Delaware's defense, and just dropped what would have been a touchdown pass. And a big one for Villanova.
Sometimes you get a little too clever. They release Forbes out of the backfield on a little skinny post. coming on a circle route, and Ray Jones was unable to defend him. He was wide open.
It's been Narza keeping it himself. He was slowed by Caleb Ashworth, and then Frank Burton made the stop. It'll be third down and about nine, so a chance for Delaware to get that offense back on the field as the offense is just trying to figure things out with Nolan Henderson as a backup. But this defense trying to get the offense another shot with 9:55 left in the second quarter, and Covington in as the running back. Ben Narza gives the quarterback. Villanova needs eight from their own 36 with a 14-7 lead. Crowd making some noise. It's a packed house here at Delaware Stadium. Ben Narza, the quarterback, awaits the snap, gets it, turns, the lefty being chased, slings it, passes caught at the 45-yard line. There is a flag. It was good for a first down. They needed eight, got nine. And now Ray Jones is being attended to. A Newark urgent care injury stoppage for Ray Jones.
Ben Narczyk was flushed out of the pocket, Cam Kitchen, and they had an under blitz coming with Kobe Reeder from left to up in the middle, and was well picked up initially, but Kitchen continues to supply terrific pressure, flushes him out, and a wonderful throw by the lefty on the run.
Changa Hodge made the catch for 9 yards.
Pass interference. Defense, number 7. It'll be an automatic first down at the spot of the foul.
Spot of the foul was about where he was tackled anyway. So there's an official's timeout. We'll stay right here. Third down and 8 becomes first down and 10. But more importantly, Ray Jones is on the field right now, being attended to by a top-notch training staff that includes Dan Watson, Brandon DeSantis, and Dr. Andrew Reisman. And as Ray Jones, one of the seniors, one of the many seniors playing on senior day here. Ray Jones, a Hodgson-Voe Tech graduate, 67 tackles on the year, 7.5 tackles for loss. He's provided such a spark, such energy on this defense all season long. Called for the penalty there, getting up onto his own 2 feet. Good sign. And he's going to walk off the field under his own strength, which is a good sign for the Hens. Looks like Kendrick Whitehead is going to come in to replace Ray Jones. Whitehead, the freshman from Middletown, Delaware, a Middletown high school graduate. He'll come in for Ray. Right now, Delaware down by 7, 9:28 left to go in the first half of football and what has been a kind of an interesting game here at Delaware Stadium.
Lots of fits and spurts here as both teams trying to regain their balance after some penalties and some interesting plays. I've been very impressed with Kobe Reeder's activity, blocking the field goal, forcing the fumble, even though unfortunately the knee was down. But he's been very active, getting involved in the blitz as well.
First and 10 from the 46 of Delaware. Forbes, he's had big holes to work with all day and bursts into Delaware territory. A 10-yard pickup for a first down.
Forbes, a very physical runner, especially at the point of attack, has a low center of gravity. That time, the left side of Villanova's line sealed off Delaware's defense and allowed Forbes to get a terrific gain.
Aaron Forbes has 47 yards rushing, one touchdown, and 38 yards through the air, catching footballs from Zach Bednarczyk. At the 44 Delaware territory, Bednarczyk takes the first and 10 snap, gives to Forbes. He gets away from Troy Reeder, bounces to the outside, Adewusi giving chase, and down Forbes goes inside the 30 at the 28-yard line. Another first down pickup for Aaron Forbes. Forbes had 140 yards rushing last year against Delaware, and he is pacing well to hit the century mark again today.
Well, Forbes has the ability to not only make the first tackler miss, but if he is hit, has great yardage after first contact. Forbes, very impressive. I was worried about him watching some tape about how physical he is.
Running back now, Jalen Jackson, the freshman. And Jackson, who got a first down pickup on a third and one earlier, going to get just a yard again, two carries for Jackson and 2 yards to show for it.
Nice job there by the front, Ashworth and Kitchen. They tried to run back to the short side. Great job of plugging their holes, establishing their gaps.
8:02, second quarter. Hens down 14-7. They went up 7-0, and all heck has broken loose since then. Villanova, big plays, turnovers, and an injured quarterback for the Blue Hens. And Ray Jones is still out of this game as he was banged up on this drive. A play action pass, Bednarczyk throwing and caught at the 15 by Matt Goodzik. Down he goes at the 10. Another first and goal to go coming up for the Villanova Wildcats.
Goodzik, very difficult to cover out of the backfield. He's got great moves, a wonderful understanding of the Villanova offense. A nice little play fake there by Bednarczyk, who does a really nice job with that activity. It looks like he's handing the ball off, which confuses the second level of Delaware's defense and allows the receiver to be open in that mid-range area.
Bednarczyk, 6 of 10 today, 155 yards thus far, 81 of them coming on a little dump-off pass to McClinton, who did the rest with his feet. But first to go to go from the 10. Villanova up 14-7. Delaware defensively looking for another stop. In motion goes McClinton, and there is a flag on the play. A timeout taken by Villanova as the play clock was winding down. So no flag as the timeout was called by Villanova. That's their second timeout, and we'll stay right here.
Well, they were misaligned. I was looking at the formation trying to figure it out, and it was not a legal one. They shifted very late. Coach Ferrante realized very quickly that they were in trouble and took the timeout to save a penalty.
Second timeout taken by Villanova of this half as they talk things over. I want to remind our listeners that the residences of Lighthouse Cove and Dewey Beach is a brand new 1, 2, and 3 bedroom luxury condominiums nestled right on Rehoboth Bay with views of the Atlantic Ocean. Residents in Lighthouse Cove enjoy great amenities. Welcome to luxury living in Dewey Beach. Whether a summer getaway or investment property, you need to explore the residences at Lighthouse Cove. Visit theresidencesde.com. So Delaware right now, looks like Ray Jones was available to come back in as he went into the huddle, but will come back to the sideline. But that's a good sign seeing Ray Jones helmet on, ready to play football as he was knocked out of the game a couple of plays ago. And right now, Villanova up to 240 total yards of offense. If they get it to 250, they'll have a touchdown. From the 10-yard line, Bell goes in motion after the timeout. Bednarczyk gives to Covington, running wide to the right. He's brought down by Adderley. Helmet pops off, but tackle is made right at the line of scrimmage. The second and goal to go from the 10.
Adderley came downhill from his safety position and did a great job of fitting into the perfect gap to stop Covington as he had to turn upfield.
And that's big that Adderley's helmet came off because he has to come out for a play. Joey Carter will come in, the sophomore from Cedar Park, Texas. Trent came to the school as wide receiver and now a secondary member of the team. So Whitehead in the game right now, Carter in the game right now, with Adderley and Jones both on the sideline. Second out, a goal to go from the 10 for Bednarczyk. Setting McClinton in motion. Bednarczyk dropping back to pass. Looking for McClinton. He was tied up with Charles Bell, and there comes the flag at the 5-yard.
Well, once in a while as a linebacker, you're going to get caught getting your hands on a receiver on a crossing route. Bell knew that he was getting out leverage there and just stuck his hand out, hoping that he wouldn't get called. But the back judge, unfortunately, saw it very clearly.
Yeah, flag thrown by Sean O'Callaghan from the back of the end zone as Bell, number 5, was guarding Jared McClinton, number 5. We'll hear the call.
Pass interference, number 5 on the defense. Spot of the foul is the 3-yard line. The ball will be placed there, first and goal.
Fresh set of downs and 3 yards to add to their total. The Wildcats up 14-7. And that's the first penalty of the day for the Delaware Blue Hens.
Good news, Buck Jones back in the game.
Buck Jones back in as you're Adderley able to get back in as well. Covington is the running back to the right of Zach Bednarczyk. 3 yards away from a score. They flip it, and Bednarczyk actually keeps it himself and gets down to the 1-yard line. Charles Bell wrapped him up just in time. So the Wildcats will be a yard away.
And Villanova will counter with a heavy formation with extra tight ends coming in the game.
An official's timeout. There's a player down on the field with 6:13 left in the second quarter, and Delaware in trouble. Down 14-7, and Villanova a yard away from adding to their total. It looks like an offensive lineman down for Villanova. Newark urgent care injury stoppage. Delaware somehow has got to find a way to not allow Villanova to get an extra yard and go down potentially 21-7 here in the first half. The injured player on the offensive line looks like Ethan Greenridge, the FCS preseason All-American, All-CAA selection, one of the best offensive linemen in the conference.
if not the best, offensive lineman in the conference. He's getting worked on by the training staff of Villanova. Already an injury to the right tackle, Brandon Hittner, today. So Ethan Greenridge moved over from his left tackle position, and now they're going to have to help the big 345-pounder off the field. Physical football today. Pat Kehoe out for Delaware, their quarterback. Ray Jones came out, back in. And now we see Ethan Greenridge being helped off the field by the training staff. Two running backs in for Villanova. They need a yard. It's Gudzik and Forbes from the one-yard line. Bednarczyk gives to Gudzik. And Matt Gudzik makes the score 20-7. Villanova.
Well, they moved the left guard, Paul Grattan, to right tackle and run behind him, pulling the left guard on an inside power play. And a nice run there by Gudzik, who is a senior, has a lot of experience, and very good in short yardage situations.
Matt Gudzik scoring his third touchdown of the season. He rushed for 121 yards against Delaware back in 2016 in this stadium. And the Hens are in some trouble here in the second quarter. 6:05 remaining. And Villanova, who has won six straight against Delaware, looking to make it 21-7. Kresge on for the extra point, nearly blocked. It sails out of the stadium, but it's good. 21-7 is the score, as we'll stay right here and talk about what Delaware needs to do to get back in this football game. They've had come from behind victories before this season in this stadium, but all the momentum on the side of Villanova as Delaware got off to such a hot start. And right now, Delaware's got to figure out what to do offensively without their junior captain, Pat Kehoe.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how Coach Rocco and Coach Simon want to see if they can kind of unleash Nolan Henderson. A terrific passer. He's already shown us some nice poise in the on the play action aspect, running the ball then after tucking it. He's very agile, and watching this young man throw for a number of years now, I would feel fully confident that he's not only in command of the offense, but has the ability to get the ball downfield.
So you guys have recently started dating?
Yes. Yeah. A little less than a month.
Coming up on 2 months now, yeah.
Cool. I want to show you guys these three Chevy SUVs. The first one is called the Trax.
Beautiful.
Do you think it would be good for moving in together?
Moving in together?
Okay. Well, this is the Chevy Equinox.
Wow. Nice.
Perfect for when you two have your first kid.
Yeah, give me some time.
Okay. This is the Traverse for when you have your five kids, two dogs, and one cat.
Oh. Five?
Well, no matter what stage of life you're in, Chevy has an SUV for you.
We have it all planned out. Thanks.
Oh, say can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Is that the offensive line and then the running backs Lee and Kane just try to take over the game. They've got to be able to establish themselves. We've got to be really precise in our blocking angles and see if we can't get a couple big plays out of our special teams that have already done a nice job of that.
Delaware returning north to south for the first time, and Adley runs up, takes it at the 8-yard line of the 15-20, looking for space, spins off one tackler, reverses course to the 20, running wide, and down it goes at the 17 as a big tackle was made by Matt Gudzik, the guy that just scored the touchdown, makes the play on special teams as Adley went backwards after the spin. Delaware's offense will come back out on the field. I do see J.P. Caruso in the huddle. I believe Nolan Henderson, who's in the middle of the huddle, will be the quarterback, though. And we'll see Kenai Kane for the first time. Caruso out there just to pat Nolan Henderson, wish him well.
And Kenai Kane, the runner, for the first time in this game. We've seen Robinson and Lee. And now we see the senior from Bridgeville, Delaware, out of Sussex Tech. Delaware start first and 10 from their own 17-yard line, down 21-7. And Henderson going to throw for the first time. It's short to Joe Walker. Skipped it to him at around the 30-yard line as the pocket was collapsing.
Well, he had no time at all to establish himself. Had to throw off his back foot because of the pressure. We see Jamie Jarman on the field. So Delaware's got to get versatile. Let's not forget about Joe Walker on some reverses or maybe a reverse pass.
Jamie Jarman playing for the first time in five games. The senior from Millsboro, Delaware. Out. Good to see Jamie. He'll be in the slot near side. Nolan Henderson on second down and 10. He'll drop back, has some more time. Pass is caught by Kenai Kane. He sheds one, gets to the 20. That would have been a loss of about two at first contact. Instead, he makes something out of it, picks up three, and it's going to be third down and seven for Delaware from the 20-yard line.
I really like the feel of this, getting the ball to Kane and Lee out in space, allow them to run after the catch, allows Henderson to get the ball out of his hands very quickly and make a throw that's very safe. So good strategy employed by Matt Simon. Offensive coordinator
has gone three and out on both possessions since Pat Kehoe has come out of the game. It's third down and seven for Delaware from the 20. Down 21-7. Rolling out is Henderson. He's going to try to run with it to the outside at the 25, 30. First down by Nolan Henderson. He started left, cut right. An official got in his way, and he was able to elude the official to find space and run. Nolan Henderson, a huge pickup, heady play by the sophomore.
Excellent decision. Sprints left. It was taken away. Immediately tucks the ball, runs right. And I just really like the way he ended up that play, stepping out of bounds. Just looks so poised doing it and very confident and comfortable in what he's doing out there.
He's been able to run the football, has Henderson three times for 21 yards, got 10 there. And the drive continues. First down, the Delaware's picked up with Nolan Henderson operating. He's out of shotgun form at his own 30-yard line. 4:30, second quarter, dropping back, throws. It's bobbled by Owen Tyler and dropped at the 35-yard line. Keeling Hunter was defending the fullback, and now Nolan Henderson is down. His head is in the turf, and he is in some pain.
They brought a blitz off Delaware's left side. It was a free runner that just as Henderson released the ball, he was hit very hard, and I don't know if it's a shoulder or whether he went down and hit the turf, but a tough, tough play for the young man.
And Nolan Henderson is 175 pounds. He is not a big guy out there, and he was hit full force by one of the Villanova players in a Newark Urgent Care injury stoppage as Nolan Henderson is down. Delaware already playing without Pat Kehoe as he was under concussion protocol and don't believe he passed the test. As we have not been able to see Pat Kehoe back in. Nolan Henderson just now sitting up upright at the 20-yard line. He was hit very hard as he threw that pass to Owen Tyler. Tyler dropped the pass and he got just drilled from the backside. Didn't see the Villanova player coming. And Henderson to his feet. He's hobbling off the field right now. Looks like maybe a lower body injury for Nolan Henderson. So Delaware will have to continue to go down their depth chart, as I would assume J.P. Caruso coming in, or perhaps we'll see some Wildcat as Joe Walker could potentially be the quarterback as well, as he started his first two seasons as the QB. We're going to see J.P. Caruso. So J.P. Caruso was the quarterback last year against Villanova, now the quarterback once again, as J.P. will be asked to move the football as the third quarterback we've seen today for Delaware. Empty backfield, four wide receivers to the left of J.P., second and 10. Caruso going to keep it. Villanova all over it as he gets to the line of scrimmage and nothing more. It's going to be third down and 10 as Keeling Hunter makes another stop.
Hunter very active. They list him as a cornerback, but he's really that hybrid outside linebacker, almost bandit-type player that Ray Jones is, always around the box. A blitzer as well as a pass defender, and doing a nice job there of coming up and securing J.P. Caruso on the quarterback draw.
Under 4 minutes to play, second quarter. Third down and 9 from their own 31-yard line. The third quarterback we've seen today is J.P. Caruso. He's got trips to the left side, including Jamie Jarman. Dejon Lee is the running back. And Caruso back to toss. has some pressure. Steps up in the pocket, hit. He wanted to throw. He's going to go down for a loss. He just couldn't find an open target, or if he did, he couldn't get it off because of the pressure by Villanova. And another punt coming up for Nick Pritchard as this clock ticks down at 3:26, and Delaware trailing 21-7.
A three-man pressure with a spy on Caruso, assuming that he might run. He was looking for Dejon Lee in the left low flat, the right low flat, but he was well covered, forced to tuck the ball.
Pritchard will kick this one away. This is as bad of circumstances as Delaware could see coming. I don't know if anyone could see this coming as Pritchard punts this one away. There was contact, maybe a flag coming as the ball rolls out of bounds at the 20, but a flag is thrown as Nick Pritchard was hit as he kicked that football away.
Well, Villanova has put a lot of pressure on the punt. Three different times they brought internal pressure against the spread punt of Delaware, almost puncturing the shield.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker on the defense. It's a 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
A big penalty for Delaware. The crowd likes it. They were going to give Villanova possession of the football. Instead, a break for the Hens gives them the rock to continue the drive, and it moves them up 15 yards. That's the biggest gain for Delaware offensively since the second drive of the game. A 15-yard penalty moves the football up 15 yards, and J.P. Caruso on the offense will stay out with Dejon Lee as the running back. Ball is placed at the 44-yard line of Delaware after the penalty on the punt. Caruso has some time to throw. He tosses it across the field, and it's secured by Joe Walker. A first down on the toss from Caruso to Joe.
Caruso had the opportunity to step into that throw, opened up his shoulders perfectly, delivers the ball to a wide open Walker. An excellent throw there by J.P. Caruso on first down, taking advantage of the brutal special teams mistake by Villanova.
A 13-yard pickup puts Delaware in Villanova territory. Caruso, the grad student, out of shotgun form, gets the snap. He wants to throw again. Pressure coming. Hit as he throws a dart. Caught by Charles Scarf at the 30. Dragging defender to the 29-yard line. And J.P. Caruso has gone back to back.
Brought the same blitz that knocked Nolan Henderson out. They send the D end inside. They bring the linebacker outside. He's a free runner. Caruso stood in just long enough to allow Scarf to get open beyond the chains. Delivers a great ball and takes a big hit on the play. Tough guy play by J.P. Caruso.
13 yards to Walker, 15 yards to Scarf. Delaware at the Villanova 28-yard line, working north to south. Caruso again wants to throw. Sidearm slings it towards the sideline to Papali, knocked out of his hands by Christian Benford, his fifth pass breakup of the season.
Another free runner off the right side of Delaware's line. Delaware sliding their protection to the left. Caruso throws off of that, and I really admire him for hanging in there, trying to allow Papali to get open. Had to hold it a little bit longer and took a pretty big hit, but he bounced right back up.
Robinson, the running back, to the left of J.P. Caruso on 2nd and 10. 1:54, second quarter. Three wide receivers to his right is Jamie Jarman rolling out to his left. Caruso on the run. Papali has to dive to grab it, and I don't believe he held on in bounds. So after two complete passes for first downs, two incompletions towards both sidelines, going to set up 3rd down and 10. For Delaware, 1:48 left to play in the second quarter.
Well, they sprint Caruso out with a little quick twist in the back to make it almost look like a bootleg, but he's rolling to his left. Had to make a tough throw there, threw the ball a little bit late, and that's why it was low.
Robinson is the running back for Caruso. Trips to left side. Zone 6, good to see them again. The nickname for Walker, Papali, and Jarman. Blitz coming, Caruso lets it go. Scarf's going to have to run for it. A stiff arm frees him to the 20. First down, Charles Scarf. He needed 10, and he got there.
Caruso took another massive hit on his right arm as he released it. But Scarf, very elusive in using that straight arm.
What an effort by Charles Scarf. And they might have to measure. They're going to call it 4th down. I don't like that spot. 4th and inches. I thought he got there, Bill.
Well, I agree with your call. Scarf almost vaulted over top of the second tackler coming in, but a big play by Scarf to get close to the first down.
4th down and a yard, and a shotgun. The offense will stay on the field. Caruso drops back, throws. It's intercepted on fourth down by Villanova. It was Drew Wiley, the linebacker who stepped in front. The Hens needed a yard out of shotgun. Caruso threw a pass into the hands of a Villanova defender.
Media timeout on the field.
He was trying to hit a crossing route, and Wiley, as you so perfectly described, jumps up and knocks the ball down. Just perfect timing by the junior linebacker.
He's trying it. It looked like he could have just batted away. Instead, he actually caught the football. So two of the big guys with interceptions. 17 INTs on the season for Villanova. Delaware drives the field, stays on fourth and one after what I thought was a first down pickup by Charles Scarf. They marked it fourth and one. Delaware needed less than a yard, probably a couple of feet. They decided to go out of shotgun form and have J.P. Caruso throw a quick toss, and instead of picking up the first down and continuing the drive, or perhaps putting three on the board. And Delaware had momentum on the drive. They wanted to continue the drive. Felt like getting seven at the end of the first half would be huge. And instead, Delaware gets nothing to show for that long drive. And with 54 seconds left in the first half, Delaware looks like they're going to trail by at least 14 heading into the locker room.
Well, Villanova very fortunate there. Right? First down saving tackle on the far side as Scarf gave a terrific effort running right to left. He is such a wonderful target with all his different quarterbacks. I love the way he uses his body. He posts up. He's got a huge catch radius, a very good blocker, and showing some really good skills there running after the catches. He had to avoid a much quicker cornerback as he came in and stiff-armed the first Villanova defender.
Villanova's offense back on the field. First and 10 from their own 19 with Delaware down 21-7. Forbes running wide to the right side of the field. He's brought down by Troy Reeder after a gain of about three.
Stop by nine, Troy Reeder.
Well, Delaware will just let the clock run out here. Villanova getting the ball at the start of the second half. So that was a huge turnaround for Villanova there to get that interception on the fourth down play to thwart Delaware inside their red zone, where they have had a lot of difficulties defending.
Villanova going to have to snap it at least one more time. 22 seconds and the first half. Van Narzik has the play clock at 14. And he'll give it to the runner. Forbes trying to bounce to the outside. Kobe Reeder is there, meeting him at the 25-yard line. And that might be the final play of the first half. A disappointing start as there's a timeout taken by Delaware. Delaware calls a timeout with 5 seconds remaining.
Timeout. Starts to Delaware. Their second time on the half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
Delaware not ready to go into the locker room. They call a timeout with 5 seconds left, down 21-7. Third down and three coming up for Villanova.
Well, the reason Coach Rocco's doing this, in case Villanova can't run off enough time, they'll be forced to run a fourth down play, which conceivably would just be a kneel down, which would take enough time if Villanova plays this right. So Villanova should strategically run the ball wide and then take a knee.
Smart decision. You never know. A chance.
Might be a bad snap. I'm surprised that Villanova hasn't worked underneath or wasn't even taking a few knees there, if nothing else, to force Delaware to use their timeouts, but more importantly, not to have a fumble occur deep in their own red.
Well, can't bring them into the locker room. Might as well use them. 5 seconds remaining for Zach Bednarczyk and this offense of Villanova, up 21-7. Delaware has one timeout left. It's third down and three for Bednarczyk. Gave his to Forbes, cuts back, he spins just long enough to keep the clock at double zero. Stayed on his feet, Delaware will go into the locker room, but we'll hear from head coach Danny Rocco. It's our halftime interview brought to you by Rufo Associates. Visit RufoLaw.com, and we'll wait for head coach Danny Rocco to get over to Corey Nido to give us some thoughts on a disappointing first half of football, but still a chance to bounce back in the second half here as Delaware trails 21-7. We'll send it to Corey Nido with
Coach
Rock.
Thanks, Scott. Coach, you said all season this team can handle adversity. Certainly has faced that in the first half. Yep. What does your team need to do to push forward and get back in this game?
We got to get something going on offense. I mean, right now, you know,
So Chevrolet at Dover off of.
The Athletic Center will be completed by the 2020 football season. There is much to be proud of here today. And thank you again to all of our generous donors. Next Thursday, the Fight Bluehead Marching Band will make its debut at the Philadelphia Thanksgiving Day Parade as the featured band. This means they are the only band allowed to stop and perform in front of the Art Museum steps to be broadcasted by 6 ABC TV for 2 to 3 minutes. Today's halftime performance will include a preview of the television feature to both East and West grandstands. fans of Fight Bluehead Marching Band is under the direction of Heidi Eisarver, professor in the Department of Music. Assistant director is James P. Ancona, assistant professor in the Department of Music. Color guard is directed by Sarah McAdams. Assistant color guard instructor is Luke Everhart. Golden Girls are instructed by Dina Frank. Staff includes Mike Windisch, Seth Hastings, Eric Gross, Brian Von Hagel, Dan Schack, Brendan Murphy, Travis Peterman, Abigail Molin, Anthony Shelton, and Rich Weaver. Graduate assistants are Jessica Evans, Lindsay Hartfelder, and Anthony McDonald Johnson. Music is written by Michael Klesch and James P. Ancona. Show design is by Heidi I. Sarver. Marching Band wishes to thank all of the generous individual supporters of the program, as well as Adams Percussion, A Wish Come True Costumes, Claymont Steak Shop, DeMolin Uniforms, First State Orthopedics, Innovative Percussion, Pearl Drums, Remo Drumheads, and Zildjian Cymbals. Please remember to join us after today's game when the band will perform their full show facing the West Grandstands. Once again, the pride of Delaware, the University of Delaware Fighting Blueheads Marching Band!
So you guys have recently started dating?
Yes. Yeah. A little less than a month.
Coming up on 2 months now, yeah.
Cool. I want to show you guys these three Chevy SUVs. The first one is called the Trax.
Beautiful.
Do you think it would be good for moving in?
Oh, say, can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Day, we announced the eighth win of the season for Delaware. They've got 30 minutes to turn things around as Villanova will get the football first. They won the toss, deferred, so Delaware will kick this one away, going north to south, the backs to the student section for Villanova. 15 minutes on the clock to start the second half of football in the third quarter with Delaware down 21-7. We'll have to wait to see who comes out on offense as the QB here for the Hens. But Jake Roth has it teed up. And it is on its way as Forbes takes it inside the end zone. He'll take a knee. Another touchback to the credit of Jake Roth. Hey, at Dash Head, you can get any size smoothie, any size coffee or cappuccino for only 99 cents. Made with 100% Arabica beans. Their coffees are bold, smooth, and rich. For a limited time, they've got pumpkin spice cappuccino, a seasonal favorite. Fall in love at first sip with Dash Head coffee. Any size for only 99 cents. Find a location near you at dashin.com.
From Villanova's standpoint, Ethan Greenridge, their terrific left tackle who's been playing right tackle today because of injuries, is back in the game.
Newark Urgent Care injury update on Greenridge, the senior 6'4", 345. Didn't know if we'd see him again the way he came off the field, but good eyes, Bill. Back in the game and able to play again. He's at that right tackle position, usually the left tackle. As the second half will start with a shotgun snap to Zach Benarczyk. He keeps, runs the option, flip to Forbes, who's hit at the 25-yard line by Casey Hinton. He bounces off, but ran out of room at the 27, maybe 26-yard line, gain of one.
That was very well defensed by Delaware. Cam Kitchen, from his defensive end position, read it perfectly. Colby Reeder comes upfield and plays it very aggressively, forces the pitch early, and then Casey Hinton in perfect position to clean up. That was really well diagnosed and defended by Delaware at the start of here in the second half. A good sign, a good omen. We need to get the offense back out with a couple of extra multiple possessions, keep the time of possession in Delaware's favor.
Hinton became a starter in the middle of the season, and they went over Elon. It was his 39th career game before he got his first start, but he's played well ever since. Now he's in coverage on the near side. It's Forbes twisting his way through the Delaware defensive line and being brought down at the 32. Going to be third down and three for Villanova. Malcolm Brown with the stop. We'll see if Delaware can't get a three and out to start this second half with some energy. And the crowd looking at Nasir Adderley and Casey Hinton and Troy Reeder. They're asking for some noise on this very full West stands underneath us in the press box. He'll get some noise. Benarczyk, third down and three from his own 32. In motion, McClinton, left to right. Benarczyk dropping back. Here comes Bell. Benarczyk across the field, and Changa Hodge cannot hold on as Charles Bell went full steam towards the quarterback, put the pressure on, and Delaware gets the three and out they were looking for.
An inside blitz by Charles Bell. He leans left and then works back quickly to his right. Villanova did not pick it up. A free runner, as Villanova had, forces Benarczyk to get the ball out of his hand very quickly. Good defense there, and a great series for Delaware to start this second half.
Punter out on the field for Villanova, Nathan Fondacaro, solid punter. Vinny Papali back to return, and Troy Reeder almost got his hand on it. This one floats up. Nasir Adderley, who went back to return pretty late, gets back in time and catches it at the 32-yard line. Let's keep an eye on the huddle now and and see who pops out. It looks like J.P. Caruso is going to be the quarterback, and he's been a starting quarterback before for Delaware. I like the decision. I don't know if Nolan Henderson is 100%, so I don't know if it was a decision or just forced to go this way, but J.P. has been here before. He's won football games for Delaware. He is a grad student. He wants to win and lead this team to the playoffs, and he's been out there on the field in this scenario against Villanova before. Lee is the running back as Delaware has it first and 10 from their own 32, and Lee looking for space to the outside. None there as he had to slow down, look for a hole that did not come about, and Drew Willie, who had an interception last time on the field, makes a tackle.
Well, Delaware wants to start out with establishing DeJuan Lee as they did so well in the early stages of the first half. A big front, Villanova applying extra men in the box here. They're really going to see if Caruso can throw the ball downfield. They're challenging him to do that.
Trying to force the grad student, transfer from App State, to throw this football. It's second down and 10. Robinson, the running back. Caruso bobbles the snap, steps up, throws on the run. It's wide for an open Joe Walker at the 40-yard line. If Joe catches that, he'll be able to spin and get first down yardage, but it was not on target. And now third down and 10 for the Blueheads.
When you haven't done or gotten a lot of reps, as J.P. Caruso hasn't, because Henderson's been getting the second reps, he's just timing with the wide receivers and the tight ends is going to be a little off. He's forced to roll there to his left. Again, very difficult for a right-hander on his first throw of the second half.
Villanova got the football first in the second half. They went three and out. Delaware trying not to do the same. It's third down and 10 from their own 32. Pressure coming. Caruso trying to escape it, throwing on the run and out of bounds. Caruso had to dump it. And a three and out for Delaware with 12:39 left in the third quarter of football. Head still down 21-7.
Michael Taylor brought great pressure from the right side by Villanova. Caruso had no opportunity to even set up. He did a very intelligent thing, sprinted out and threw the ball away. A little change there offensively in the line. Noah Bay has moved to right guard. Connor Lutz playing the left guard position.
Josh
with
McGrig,
Pepe in at right tackle.
Josh McGrig back to return. Last time Pritchard was out, a roughing the kicker penalty. Kept the drive alive this time. No contact, but a good punt from Pritchard. Caught the 25-yard line. Contact there, and Nasir. Excuse me. It was Justice Henley, I believe, on coverage. The freshman who slammed into McGrig, and good special teams coverage there. Puts Villanova with the football at their own 28, and we'll take a timeout. 12:30 remaining in the third quarter, and Villanova's second possession of the second half coming up. Up 21-7.
Come experience a new direction in healthcare. Star Health at the University of Delaware, offering the health services you need to stay well and feel great. A nurse-managed primary care center, nutrition counseling, exercise counseling, health coaching, speech, language, and hearing services, and a nationally renowned physical therapy clinic. Using the power of University of Delaware research and education in one integrated clinical setting. It's all under one roof on UD Star Campus. Visit udel.edu/starhealth to learn more about a new direction in healthcare.
When you find yourself in need of legal advice, you need a lawyer that will sit down and spend time with you. You need a good listener. You need someone with history and experience to give you good advice, and if necessary, you need a strong advocate with the courtroom skills to make sure that justice is served. You need Rufo Associates, nationally recognized as a leader in serious and complex litigation. Rufo Associates is proud to offer services no matter how big or how small your legal issue may be. Call Rufo Associates at 302-234-5900 or visit rufolaw.com. That's rufolaw.com.
The 20th season of Blue Hens Football on 94.7 WDSD.
Delaware's best cheesesteaks are at Claymont Steak Shop. Try their delicious award-winning cheesesteaks at any of their three locations in Newark, Wilmington, and Claymont. Claymont Steak Shop is perfect for your tailgate. Order online at claymontsteakshop.com. Delaware back on defense, a three and out for Villanova, three and out for the Blueheads, and now the Wildcats back with the football, no damage done. After punting it away to the Hens, 21-7, the Villanova lead right now, and Zach Bednarczyk with his team out on the field, a six-game winning streak against Delaware for the Wildcats. They're trying to extend that today from Newark. Forbes up the middle, runs into Colby Reeder, or actually Colby Reeder, I should say, ran right into him. A nice tackle by the sophomore.
Well, nice job by Reeder working down the line of scrimmage. He does a great job of keeping his shoulders square to the line of scrimmage, which allows him to have a full surface when he goes to tackle. A very heady play there by the sophomore.
12:07 and ticking. Zach Bednarczyk is the quarterback. He's battled some injuries. Delaware offensively, they had an injured starting quarterback in Pat Kehoe out with a concussion. Bednarczyk did not play in the game last year because of injury against Delaware. On second down and 10, Bednarczyk surveying the field. No one open. He's going to tuck and try to run. No, he's going to pull it back and look again. Now he's going to try to run again. Throws it out of bounds. He had seemingly minutes back there. And a flag is thrown late after the ball went out of bounds.
Tremendous coverage downfield by Delaware. That'll be a coverage throwaway if nothing else.
There is no foul for an ineligible downfield. The ball was legally thrown out of bounds. No intentional grounding.
They pick up the flag, as you heard from the official Jeff Gray. But now we have third down and 10 again for Villanova. 11:42, third quarter. Delaware looking to get their second straight. Three and out. Drew Nichols into the game. The freshman will be on the line with Caleb Ashworth and Big Cam Kitchen. They'll move up Colby with Bell, Reeder, and Jones as the linebackers. Goodzik, who has one touchdown today, is the runner. To left is Zach Bednarczyk. Crowd making noise. From their own 28, Villanova needs 10. On third down, dropping back Bednarczyk. Ball deflected, a diving interception by Cam Kitchen. Giving it all he's got on senior day. Cam Kitchen, the 6'2", 275-pound senior from Trenton, New Jersey, dove and got the pick after the deflection at the line. Could be a huge break that Delaware needed. And now Cam is down on the field being attended to a Newark Urgent Care injury stoppage as he gets looked at. But that's the effort play that could spark this Delaware team.
Well, a great job there of getting their hands up at the line of scrimmage. Was that Ashworth that got the deflection? And then Cam Kitchen, unbelievably alert for such a big man, dives on the ground and is able to secure it. A nice job there by Delaware's defense to put pressure on Bednarczyk, flush him out of the pocket at times, as they did on the play before. And that time he was forced to stay in there because of the inward pressure. Kitchen in perfect position.
Just an amazing play by Cam Kitchen, the big defensive lineman. He had that huge interception against New Hampshire to change some things around. And now he's going to give Delaware possession of the football around the 25-yard line. That's where Cam is sitting upright right now as he's being attended to. He's up to his feet, which is a good sign. I believe it was Caleb Ashworth who did tip it, Bill, and now Ashworth helping out Cam Kitchen get to the sideline. His teammates helping him out. Ashworth and Tenny Adewusi. Tenny is Cam's roommate, helping him to the field. They are looking at the play as Cam comes off the field. They are going to review it. And I won't make any predictions because I've been wrong today on these reviews.
So would a lot of people.
They reviewed a Nasir Adderley safety that would have been made it 2-0 Villanova. And they overturned that. They reviewed a fumble forced by Colby Reeder. Reviewed it, overturned that. So two overturns today of calls. A break for Delaware on one, a break for Villanova on the other. If this does not go Delaware's way, it'll be fourth down for Villanova. If it goes Delaware's way, they'll have the football first and 10 at the Nova 27. The backup quarterback, third string quarterback, J.P. Caruso, at the helm. This is a big review here for Delaware as momentum could really swing for the Hens. Cam Kitchen possessed that football. I'm watching it again on our screen, and Cam Kitchen caught it, rolled over. I think what the review is for is when he got up with the ball came loose, but he rolled over with the football. That's a football move to me. He was tackled by an offensive lineman, Paul Gratton. So as I look at it, I don't see any way this ball could be reversed, only because he caught it, and then he spun on the ground, was touched by a player, meaning he was down by contact, and he was on the ground anyway, so in college football you don't have to be touched.
if your knee is down. And we'll take a listen.
After review, the defensive player controlled the ball, but in the process of going to the ground, lost control of the ball. There is no interception. This will just be an incomplete pass. It'll be fourth and 10 at the 28-yard line. Game clock operator, please set the game clock to 11 minutes, 42 seconds. 11, 4, 2.
He said he controlled the football going to the ground, and then the ball came out. He was on the ground when he had control of the football. He would be down if he had control of the football while on the turf. I don't necessarily understand the explanation we were given. So instead of Delaware having the football at the 27-yard line, Villanova will punt this one away, and Delaware gets the football back either way, but they would have been 7 yards out of the red zone. Instead, Vinny Papale and Nasir Adderley are back to return. So the third reverse call of the day, and an already just odd football game. The way things have gone, Delaware was searching for momentum, and instead, a punt coming up by Villanova. Papale waving for it at the 41-yard line on Delaware's side of the field. And kind of takes the excitement out of what Cam Kitchen did. I watched it several times. I heard the explanation from Jeff Gray. And Delaware going to come back out on the field after we come out of a timeout. We'll take a break. 11:36 remaining in the third quarter. A lot of football left. Delaware down 21-7.
Stop stopping. Easy Pass is accepted in 16 states, helping to take more people more places fast. Get your Easy Pass online at ezpassde.com. Easy Pass.
Soon be here. Newark Urgent Care provides flu shots for $25, and they are available 24/7 on your schedule. Visit them at newarkurgentcare.org.
You're listening to 94.7 WDSD, celebrating 20 seasons as the home for Blue Hens football.
Welcome back into Delaware Stadium, where the Hens trail 21-7. An overturned interception by Cam Kitchen. Delaware gets the football back instead of at the Nova 27, at their own 41-yard line, first and 10. And we see another change at quarterback as J.P. Caruso comes back out of the game. And now Nolan Henderson comes back in. For those just joining us, Pat Keough knocked out of the game due to a concussion on an interception thrown in the second quarter. First and 10. For Nolan Henderson, they'll go RPO. Henderson using his feet to buy some time. Slings it towards the sideline. Pass is caught by Joe Walker. A pickup to midfield. A 9-yard gain on first down.
Not only does he have good speed out on the perimeter to avoid tacklers, he's very elusive in the pocket. Does a great job of understanding where the pressure is coming from. He steps up and then slide steps and is able to throw on the run. That was a big component of his offense in high school, was throwing sprint outs and quick passes on the move, which he's very good at.
Delaware at midfield, second down and a yard needed. Andre Robinson is the running back. Transfer from Penn State, changes direction and picks up the first down. That was going to be a tackle for loss of about three. Would have set up third down and four. Instead, he changed directions and got the first down into Villanova territory. Delaware going to go quickly with a no huddle. Robinson remains the running back. Nolan Henderson is the quarterback at a shotgun four. Two wide receivers to the right and Papale to his left. Henderson going to throw again. Walker has his man beat. The toss by Henderson is incomplete, but a flag is thrown. It'll be pass interference, and Delaware moving the football on offense.
We talk about the short passing game of Delaware, especially Nolan Henderson, but he's also very good at throwing that deep seam pass. I saw him do it an awful lot in the past.
Number 41 in the defense. The penalty will be 15 yards from the previous spot. First down.
And in spring practice, I was very impressed with his ability to throw the ball down the field, as well as his short-range accuracy.
Nolan Henderson, the former Gatorade Player of the Year in the state of Delaware, a champion at Smyrna. Tossed it to Walker, lots of contact. Christian Benford was beat. And the pass interference likely saved a touchdown. As it's first and 10, ball at the 32 of Villanova. Dejon Lee back in as the running back. As Nolan Henderson has his offense moving a bit. Lee, big hole up the middle, a burst of speed brings him to the 25-yard line. That's a pickup of 8 yards on first down.
And a nice changeup. Robinson, who does a good job with the power running, much like Kenai Kane. Then they come back to Dejon Lee, who has a very explosive burst at the point of attack. And that was ultimately a little seam developed in the right side of the offensive line. He exploits it.
Lee up to 73 yards on 11 carries. Delaware 5 yards away from the red zone. This is where they would have had the football had Cam Kitchens' interception counted. So they get back the yardage. Nolan Henderson, a give to Lee. Changing directions with speed at the 10, down at the 5.
What a terrific run by Lee. Starting left, working back right. The box had 8 defenders in it, and he found a way to find about the only seam in the defense as he cut back to the right to almost score.
A gain of 23 yards. Lee's got 94 today. He's got 1 touchdown. Delaware trying to score for the first time since the opening possession. It's first and goal to go from the 4. Hens trail 21-7. 9:46 and ticking third quarter. Nolan Henderson is the quarterback. Sends Papali in motion, left to right. Henderson gives to Lee. Lee shuffles steps and he picks up a yard to the 2.
Just change up there by Delaware. They went with the unbalanced, but with Charles Scarf is the right tackle. And he's provided a terrific block, but Villanova's defense rallied very quickly. I like the change-ups here of formation that Matt Simon's utilizing.
Henderson in control of the huddle. Clock at 23 seconds on the play clock. They'll go I form. DeMalley the fullback. Lee the running back. Second and goal from the 2. 2 wide receivers to the left. Under center goes Nolan Henderson. Give is to Lee. Lee ducks into the end zone for a touchdown. His second of the day.
And the changeup on the right side of the line with Noah Bay as the right guard and Pepe as the right tackle. They motion, and then they lead with Lee in a really great scoring drive, running behind the right side, kind of a shuffled up offensive line on the right side, providing the impetus.
That is a huge play, as now Delaware a chance to be down only 1 score with a lot of football left, and the confidence builder that drive must be for the sophomore from Smyrna, Nolan Henderson. Pritchard will hold. High snap, Pritchard gets it down. Frank Rago gets it through, and Delaware is back in the ballgame. 21-14, we'll take a timeout with 8:56 remaining in the third.
Mark your calendars now for the 64th DFRC Blue Gold All-Star Football Game on June 22nd, 2019 at Delaware Stadium. Be a part of this Delaware tradition that works to celebrate the abilities of people living with intellectual challenges and enrich the lives of Delawareans with intellectual disabilities. Enjoy the game that brings together football players, cheerleaders, ambassadors, band members, and buddies from more than 50 Delaware high schools. It's so much more than one night in one game. Help support the DFRC Blue Gold All-Star Football Game today at dfrc.org.
People's Plaza will be holding their annual Turkey-thon on Monday, November 19th from 4 to 7 p.m. in front of Safeway. They will be collecting donations of turkeys and non-perishable food items for the Delaware Food Bank to provide for those less fortunate. That's Turkey-thon on November 19th. People's Plaza is located in Glasgow near the intersection of Routes 40 and 896. People's Plaza, eat, shop, and more. They do have it all. Follow us on Facebook at People's Plaza DE or online at peoplesplaza.com.
Delaware football is on 94.7 WDSD FM and iHeartRadio.
Delaware goes 6 plays, 59 yards, taking 2:40 off the clock, and they've got themselves back in this ballgame. 21-14, Villanova leads. Nolan Henderson led the drive. Dejon Lee, 3 straight carries, 21 yards, 2 yards, and 2 more for a touchdown to finish the drive. Lee up to 98 yards rushing and 2 touchdowns. I'm Scott Klatcher alongside Bill Harmon in the booth. Let's send to the sideline and Corey Nido.
Thank you, Scott. Well, we'll see if Cam Kitchen, the defensive lineman, will be back out for the Blue Hens. You mentioned the injuries of today's game. Obviously, Pat Kehoe, Nolan Henderson. You also add Cam Kitchen and then Ray Jones getting banged up. It will be a big addition and boost if Cam Kitchen can return to this game. It was a right knee injury, and we'll see if he comes out, Scott.
Thank you, Corey. A lot of Newark urgent care injury updates in today's game. If you're just following along, Pat Kehoe knocked out of the game with a concussion. We see Nolan Henderson. We see J.P. Caruso. And Nolan Henderson just led a 59-yard drive. 8:56 remaining in the third. Plenty of football left, but the boost that that must give Nolan Henderson and the rest of the team and the rest of the stadium to know, hey, we might be in good hands here with Henderson. Roth, this one is a sky kick. Forbes will take it 1 yard deep into the end zone. 5-10 yard line, got space at the 15. The 20, 25, dragged down from behind as he gets to the 30-yard line. Whitehead on the stop, and Villanova will take over on offense. But just touch on the big confidence boost.
No one is a confident, and I don't mean in any way other than that, young performer. But what that does for him, especially the ability to throw the ball downfield. He's got that bad foot, was bandaged up. I watched him in pregame or in halftime warm-ups look very solid out there. He's able to step into his throws. He can make plays with his feet. A huge boost for Delaware's offense.
Armin Ware is the defensive end in replacement of the injured Cam Kitchen, who is still on the sideline. First and 10 for Bednarczyk, throwing to Changa Hodge. He lost that one in the sun. He turned to get the football, couldn't find it in the sun, beating down on the field. An incomplete pass to Hodge.
That's the second week. Delaware had troubles in the fourth quarter up at Stony Brook, yeah, right, as they were attacking with the sun. And I'm always a little confused. The offensive coordinator for Villanova should probably recognize that, throw it a little bit further out up the field where he can use his shoulder pads to cover the sun, or throw it away from the sun into the left boundary.
8:45, third quarter. Villanova not been able to move the football in the second half thus far. Third possession of the third quarter for Nova. Crowd making some noise on second and 10. Forbes to the right side. He bounces off one, changes direction, stays on his feet, picks up five as Frank Burton caught him from behind. A shifty runner. We got two guys that can change direction very quickly in Dejon Lee and Aaron Forbes today.
Started right, cut back immediately to his left, almost avoided Frank Burton, who's really done a nice job in his minutes, coming in and working hard down the line, playing that two-gap position to allow the linebackers to flow.
This crowd might erupt. It's a third down stop here. Let's take a listen. Third and five. Low snap. Bednarczyk throwing. Pass is caught. That's a first down. It'll extend the drive to the 41. Nice play call by Villanova. Needed five. Easy pitch and catch from Bednarczyk.
That Ryan Bell that we talked about in the pregame show, who's had a wrist injury, a senior, coming in with 29 catches into this game after missing a number, posted up right at the stakes. Bednarczyk delivers the ball just where he could catch it down low. A nice pitch and catch for that first down by Villanova.
Moves it to the 41. Fresh set of downs. Jalen Jackson, the fullback in the game. He'll get the carry, running wide, pushing to the 45-yard line. Again, a four-on first down. They've worked Jackson and Covington. Scott, some carries, but it's been mostly Aaron Forbes, who's up to 86 yards and a score.
Well, I think every time that Aaron Forbes doesn't carry the ball, that's a win for Delaware. Forbes, very elusive, has really impressed me this afternoon with his ability to run both inside and outside. We've also seen him as a pass receiver, very good out in space. Look, yep, for Villanova to come back to that at some point.
Forbes over 100 yards total offense in this game. Jackson remains the runner. In motion, McClendon from left to right on second down and six. And Bednarczyk will throw to McClendon. Pass is caught at the 50-yard line. Staying in bounds for a few extra to the 42. Went McClendon into Delaware territory. The roar of the crowd you may have heard was Troy Reeder, who smacked the runner who got the fake, but did not have the football.
Excellent execution there by the quarterback Bednarczyk as he rolls to his left and makes for a very easy throw on that bootleg action.
McClendon up to two catches with 94 yards after that one. 6:33, third quarter of football. Villanova up 21-14. They'll snap it from the Delaware 42-yard line. With Bednarczyk out of shotgun form. The runner, Jackson, pump fake, throwing down the field, has Hodge. And he found his man at the 5-yard line. Down he goes at the 2. A huge pickup of 40 yards. Call it 39. They'll mark it at the 3 as Casey Hinton was beat in coverage.
Well, Hodge had one-on-one coverage, as you mentioned, with Hinton. Just a little bit of a seam route, a perfectly delivered ball by Benarczyk as it even hung up into the wind. A really well-delivered throw. Not enough pressure on the quarterback at that point.
Casey Hinton was stumbling, trying to get back into coverage. And now it's first and goal to go from the 3 for Villanova, trying to build a 14 lead back up and answer a Delaware touchdown drive. It's Forbes trying to dive and reach for the end zone. He got there. The Wildcats with an answer.
Running out of the pistol, a quick hitter up the middle as they pull and almost loop in the right guard, Dumas, to make the play. Forbes very good around the goal line because of his demeanor, keeping his pad level extremely low.
27-14 the score. After that touchdown run by Aaron Forbes, 3 yards, Forbes' second touchdown, and an answer for Villanova on offense after Delaware made it a 7-point gain. The lead back up to 13, a chance to make it 14 with the extra point on the way from Drew Kresge. And Tanya Nawusi's come close a couple times in this game to get the block, but not that time. As the ball goes through and the score 28-14. So if you're Delaware, you're saying to your team, all right, let's go out there. We got to do it again.
And they certainly have the capability of doing that. Get good field position on this kickoff. Let Henderson start working inside and out as he's done. And I like the fact that Coach Simon and Coach Rocco have the confidence to let this young player throw the ball vertically down the field.
It was that pump and go that set up the touchdown. That's the second time today that a huge pass by Bednarczyk has set up a touchdown on the next play, as Bednarczyk went 81 yards, a little dump off, but Clinton ran for probably 75 of the yards. Set up first down and goal to go from the 6. Next play, Bednarczyk scored. That was the first touchdown of the day for Villanova. On that drive, a 39-yard connection from Bednarczyk to Changa Hodge. Next play, a touchdown for Aaron Forbes. So the Hens allowing 213 yards through the air, 331 total yards of Villanova offense, and find themselves again down by 14 with a backup quarterback in the action coming up. Nolan Henderson, the QB today after Pat Kehoe out with a concussion.
Still very important that Delaware sticks to the DeJean Lee running the ball and then the play action passing. That relieves pressure. It also allows Delaware to start building that confidence that Henderson just doesn't have to drop back and throw every time.
Short kick bouncing at the 12 off the hop. Adderley takes it at the 20-yard line, running wide, tripped up at the 22. That tackle made by Drew Wiley, who's having a really good day today. Slow to get up near the sideline is Nasir. He's crawling over to the sideline, gets up under his own strength, and will go to meet his teammate. Hobbling a bit is Nas, but seemingly all right. As the offense will come back out onto the field, and we've seen Dejon Lee, we've seen Andre Robinson, really haven't seen much of Kenai Kane. He has one catch for 3 yards, no carries in this game. He was banged up against Stony Brook and perhaps missing some practice time, allowing Robinson to move up the depth chart as well. First and 10 at the Delaware 22-yard line. On the play fake, Nolan Henderson avoids the rush. Will tuck, turn the corner at the 30. Down the sideline and out of bounds at the 37-yard line. Nolan Henderson with some speed picking up the first down.
He's very quick at deciding when he wants to leave the pocket. He stays in there long enough to allow his receivers to run their routes. When covered, he then pulls it and tucks it, and as you mentioned, has the basic speed just to outrun people, and that's on a bad ankle that's heavily taped up, and a smart play for Henderson to step out of bounds.
The pickup of 16 yards from Henderson makes it first down and 10 at the 38 of Delaware. Give is to Robinson this time, spinning and picking up about 5 yards, a good chunk on first down. Andre Robinson, transfer from Penn State, 38 carries, 196 yards, and 6 touchdowns in 22 games at Penn State. He was the backup last year to Saquon Barkley on that Indy Lions team.
I've been impressed as Robinson's gotten more carries recently, and in this game, he starts to get a feel for the timing with the offensive line, and I think he's taking the place for the banged up Kenai Kane, and then they come in with Lee for the changeup.
4:30 and ticking, third quarter, Delaware down 14 once again after Delaware scored
Villanova had an answer. Second down and four on the Delaware 44-yard line. It's Robinson again hesitating, stopping, and then finding a hole. A patient run by Robinson. He gets back-to-back 5-6 yard runs and a first down for Delaware.
Left side of Delaware's offensive line now starting to establish themselves. Chuka out front through a really nice block that allowed Robinson to cut back for the first down. Robinson, as you mentioned, has the power, but at times he possesses some really good patience in running, waiting for the holes to set up in the zone blocking scheme.
Robinson will remain the runner, standing next to Nolan Henderson, the backup quarterback, on first and 10 for the Delaware 49. Henderson will throw, man open, his scarf out of bounds, and a first down into Villanova territory at the 38. Fourth catch of the day for Charles Scarf.
Nolan Henderson with plenty of time back there to survey the scene, and why not throw the ball to 6'6 Charles Scarf, who runs really great crossing patterns, makes himself available by turning his shoulders fully open to the quarterback.
13-yard pickup. Henderson calling for it. Movement, and they got Villanova to jump. Pretty clean second half of football. Eight penalties against Villanova in that first half, and possibly another one coming as Delaware saying it was Nova who moved, not Delaware.
Where's the ball being snapped? False start, 65 on the offense.
It's Delaware. That's first Noah Bay, who's back in his right tackle position. And Noah Bay moved. See the reaction on the sideline for Delaware coaching staff. They thought it was Villanova who caused the jump by coming offside. So Delaware, momentarily at least, moving backwards. First and 15. At the Nova 43-yard line. 3:20 left in the third quarter. I thought Villanova moved, and that's why Noah Bay
jumped.
Not
sure. He had the opportunity to come back since there was no contact from the neutral zone, and then Delaware's Bay moved.
Henderson on first and 15. Pressure coming. Henderson standing in the pocket, tossing to Joe Walker for a touchdown. 43 yards. And the former quarterback, Joe Walker, receiving it from Delaware's newest QB, Nolan Henderson.
Nolan Henderson surveyed the scene. He was able to stay upright in the pocket. The line held the Villanova edge pressure off. He steps into that post route throw to Joe Walker going right to left. An excellent pattern and a wonderfully timed ball at just the right height down the field by Nolan Henderson.
I was watching Vinny Papale on the shorter post route, and he got lit. I thought a flag would be coming, and then I see, no, there's a man behind Papale. It's Joe Walker, and a quick strike by Delaware makes it 28-21. Blue Hens back within seven. A lot of football left. 2:56 remaining in the third quarter of action. What a strike by the sophomore from Smyrna, playing in his first game of the season. Corey, you had a good view of it down on the sideline. What a play, what a drive by the Hens, Corey.
Absolutely, Scott. And this Blue Hens sideline is rallying around Henderson. As soon as the young quarterback came over to the sideline, he was greeted by about 6 to 7 teammates, giving him bear hugs, pats on the helmet. They feel that they can trust this young quarterback to lead them to this comeback win. And with throws like that, I don't see why not, Scott.
It was just a perfect pass. What a throw from Nolan Henderson. And Bill, you're a high school football coach in the area as well. You've seen him made plenty of throws like that in his time.
Yes, and I think the book on Henderson was he's very mobile and elusive in the pocket. He can throw the short routes, the tear screens, the rockets, the checkdowns. Could he throw the deep ball? I saw him do that in particular in the blue gold game, which I did, and he was terrific at throwing those deep seams and deep posts. He's able to step into the throw. He has a much better arm than people give him credit for with that thin frame.
He was threw a rifle that time into the hands of Joe Walker. Jake Roth kicks this one in the end zone, as he's done time and time again. 36th touchback of the season off the leg of Jake Roth in Villanova. And Delaware getting chatty on the far sideline. Adewusi, Adderley, as some players from Villanova, Forbes, and others come out. Nothing too extra as both teams get back to their huddle, but the emotion riding high. So here we're in similar situation. Delaware scores, momentum
within seven. Villanova with the football after a touchback. And Delaware, chance to defend and make sure Villanova cannot extend that lead back up to 14. 2:56 remaining in the third quarter of football. And Bednarczyk and his offense back out onto the field. Still no sign of Cam Kitchen as Brandon Hall is out there on the defensive line. Kitchen still on the sideline with an injury. He's hobbling. Doesn't look like a guy that's going to return to this football game. Play action. Bednarczyk will throw towards the Delaware sideline. Too wide and incomplete. He was looking for Jarrett McClinton. It'll be second down and 10.
Well, excellent coverage over there by Tenny Adewusi and Ray Jones. It was a wild open field throw by Bednarczyk. I'm not sure that's one that Sam Venuto, the offensive coordinator, likes to see. So Villanova started out the last couple drives with throwing on first down and then running on second and then putting the ball in Bednarczyk's hands on third down.
Trips to the left side for Bednarczyk as they operate right to left. They run on second down and it's four. It's being chased and dragging two defenders, Jones and Bell, for a 12-yard pickup on second and 10, moving the sticks.
Running behind his terrific right tackle who's converted, Ethan Greenridge, did a nice job there of sealing off almost 1.5 defenders on the left side of Delaware's line. Forbes has great leg action, and it takes a couple people to bring him down, especially if he gets into the open field with that momentum.
Forbes up over 100 yards rushing in back-to-back seasons against Delaware. Had 140 last year against the Hens. He's got 103 and two touchdowns after that run. First and 10 at the Nova 39-yard line. It'll be Covington on the counter play as he gets to the 41, maybe 42, a gain of three on first down as the clock ticks at 2:07, third quarter.
Villanova ran a little counter action there. The play starts to the left and immediately weaves back to the right. Delaware in terrific position over there to defend that. Ashworth and Colby Reeder.
Covington ran for 62 yards last year against Delaware, final game of his freshman campaign. Now a sophomore from Cardinal Hayes High School in Bronx, New York. Covington 12 yards on four carries today. Second down for Villanova. 7 yards to go from the 42 on their own side of the field. Bednarczyk is going to throw this time. Stepping up in the pocket. And he has his favorite target, Ryan Bell, at the 30-yard line and inside the 30 to the 27. Another big chunk pickup by Villanova, and it was the tight end that time.
Bell run in, deep crossing pattern right to left into the middle of the field. Bednarczyk had enough time to step up in the pocket and to allow that pattern to develop against Delaware's zone.
Delaware's defense on the field banged up a bit as Cam Kitchen not out there. And now we see Justice Henley, the freshman, at the cornerback position on first and 10 for Villanova. And Delaware's side of the field at the 27-yard line. Third quarter action under a minute to play. Forbes running to the left side. Got caught up by Charles Bell. Colby Reeder was there as well. See Sal Morrow coming into the game, placing Frank Burton on second down.
Morrow getting an opportunity here due to the injury to Cam Kitchen. This young man's battled back from some injuries. He's very tough along the line of scrimmage. Really does a nice job of utilizing his hands and setting an edge when he does get an opportunity to play.
Second down and 10. 27 ticks left on the third quarter clock. Goodzik in. Ashes Bell and Forbes all standing with Bednarczyk in shotgun form. McClinton to the near side. Far side is Changa Hodge, who had a 39-yard pickup on the last drive. Bednarczyk back to throw. Here comes Troy Reeder and throwing it behind Forbes, but caught at the 10-yard line. And it's another first and goal to go situation as the third quarter going to come to a close. Eight on the clock, and they'll switch sides of the field once they start the clock back up. It'll tick down to zeros and 15 minutes left in this game with Delaware down by seven and the Wildcats 10 yards away from going back up 14. The fourth quarter coming up. It's the Battle of the Blue, Delaware, Villanova on 94.7 WDSD.
Acme has everything you need to make your holiday meal complete. Hors d'oeuvres, fresh seafood, turkey, fresh fruits and veggies, and don't forget the dessert. Acme, your favorite local supermarket.
Klondike Kate's Restaurant on Main Street is not only the home for the Blue Hens Football Coaches Show, but also the place for amazing specials. This season, celebrate Delaware football by wearing blue and gold to Klondike Kate's on Sunday and receive 20% off from 4 to 9 p.m. Plus, don't miss Half Price Burger Night on Mondays and take part in the Newark tradition that is Half Price Nachos every Tuesday at Kate's. Visit KlondikeKates.com. Klondike Kate's on Main Street, a proud supporter of Blue Hens Football.
Why choose Excel for your office equipment? Because it really is all about the more. More selection, more personal service, more commitment to our community. Call 453-1500.
This is Dr. Michael Axe of First State Orthopedics, the team of top docs taking care of Delaware from the beach to the bridge and beyond. For more FSO information, go to our website, firststateortho.com.
The 20th season of Blue Hens Football on 94.7 WDSD.
15 minutes left in this football game. Villanova has won 11 of the last 12 against the Blue Hens and 6 in a row. The Hens favored in this one, but throw out the records when these two teams get together. It's been that way today. A crazy football game filled with reversals of calls and injured players. Pat Kehoe knocked out of the game with a concussion earlier in the contest. We've seen J.P. Caruso and Nolan Henderson as the quarterbacks for the Hens. The Delaware offensively, led by Henderson, have scored on the last two possessions, but Delaware has not been able to hold Villanova scoreless on the return drives by the Wildcats. And right now, Villanova, as we start the fourth quarter, will have it first and goal to go from the 10-yard line. 28-21. I'm Scott Klaskin here on 94.7 WDSD FM alongside Bill Harmon, Corey Nido, our sideline reporter. Delaware looking to punch their eighth win of the season and essentially their ticket into the FCS playoffs. There are several scenarios that can occur where Delaware can still make the playoffs with 7 wins, but you don't want to back into the playoffs, and certainly don't want to put the call in the hands of the committee, because we saw where that got Delaware last season as the odd man out, as New Hampshire was chosen out of the CAA over Delaware. The Hens trying to put it in their own hands, and they need to get a stop to help their chances. First and goal to go from the 10-yard line for Villanova. They go north to south as we see it from the ValleyDaysFuel.com broadcast booth. The man in motion for Ben Narzik. Got a shotgun form to start the fourth quarter of action. It's Forbes running straight into a Delaware player at the 9-yard line. It was Caleb Ashworth, who had 12 tackles a week ago, the transfer from Cincinnati.
Ashworth, incredibly mobile, works down the line of scrimmage as well as anybody on Delaware's team. Did a great job there of beating the cutback by Forbes as he was going right, cuts back hard to his left. Ashworth skimming down the line of scrimmage in perfect position to make the play.
Villanova 4 of 6 today in the red zone. On the season, just 65%, one of the worst in the country. Today, much better. Second down and 8. A man in motion is McClendon. They'll fake to him. Benarczyk throwing to Bell. Touchdown. Ryan Bell made it look easy. He was wide open at about the 4-yard line and able to walk in. Ryan Bell's 5th touchdown of the season. The man that missed most of the year with a wrist injury makes the score 34-21 Wildcats.
Well, Bednarczyk does such a nice job with this play faking and the ability to slip Bell out into the left flat. And Bell and Bednarczyk have played a number of years together, both seniors. They really have a good relationship, much like Kehoe and Charles Scarf, the tight ends. Both teams utilizing tight ends, especially effectively in the red zone.
You'd hope that Delaware's defense would be the team that could answer, as Delaware's offense with a bunch of question marks. Delaware offsides as Ray Jones got into the holder. Whistle was blown on the extra point. You would hope the Delaware defense would be able to answer and make a stop against this Villanova offense, as it's Delaware's offense has had trouble. They've been able to score the last two possessions, and Delaware just not
offside.
Able to
defense number 54.
Hold the Wildcats.
Half the distance in the goal, still the try.
Well, one of the secrets to Villanova's attack today has been their ability to run the ball so successfully with Forbes. That sets up the play action. And then, of course, the return of Benarczyk, who is really savvy back there. He's run this offense for 4 years, a lot of experience in big games, even though his record doesn't show it this season. 3-4 is the starter, but 19-14 overall showing a lot of what I would just call senior leadership back there this afternoon.
35-21, the score now as Villanova drove down the field and got a score. 14-16 remaining, and Delaware's going to have another fourth quarter comeback if they want to win their eighth game of the season, a number Delaware has not gotten to in quite some time. It's the second year in a row that Delaware comes into the final week of the season against Villanova, against a Villanova team that does not have a winning record on the year, and a chance to get their eighth win. And Villanova beat Delaware a season ago, and they are up 14 now as we get the fourth quarter started.
Well, I think Delaware continues to throw the ball downfield with Henderson, intersperse it with some runs by Lee and Robinson, who's been very impressive here this afternoon, and have the offensive line hold up. The protection has been much better in the second half, so some nice adjustments by the offensive staff, in particular Billy Polian, the offensive line coach, kind of working some different combinations from time to time, depending on the situation in the series, and a nice job of utilizing personnel as Delaware's offense been in the second half.
Eight plays, 75 yards, 3:40 off the clock on that drive for Villanova. Delaware needs another strike, and they're going to have to get some type of turnover or takeaway on defense. Natalie jogging up to get it at the 10, changing directions, but he is tripped up as the ball came out late. He was down at the 16-yard line. That's an excellent tackle in space by Joseph Sotomayor, the senior linebacker for Villanova.
Terrific coverage by Villanova as they intentionally kicked the ball short. They wanted to see if they...
First down, Delaware. Just describing that the ball, as we described it, was down first before it came out.
They wanted to hem Delaware in deeper than the 25. Let's not forget, by rule in college, you can fair catch a ball between there and get the ball to 25 if you so choose.
No Dejon Lee on the return game today. Nasir Adderley back to return kicks for the first time since that New Hampshire return. Robinson remains the running back for the second straight possession. Play fake. Henderson scrambling, throwing high for an open Andre Robinson at the 20-yard line, off target on the toss as the pressure came from Henderson. He had Robinson just kind of rush his throw a bit.
He drops back, then spins quickly to his right shoulder and rolls out left. Was a little off balance as some pressure came up the field. He did have Robinson in the low flat, a nice concept to slip him out late, almost on a delay screen.
We haven't seen Dejon Lee since he scored his second touchdown of the game. 14 carries, 98 yards for Lee. It's Robinson again, and Bryce DeMalley into the game at the tight end position. Henderson, backup quarterback. Kehoe out with a concussion. Drops back, dropped the football. Henderson, I believe, got under it. He didn't possess the football, but on the essentially play action, dropped the football after making contact with Andre Robinson. So after two very solid drives leading in scores for Delaware, Henderson backed up, third down and 14, and not only backed up with 14 yards to go, but backed up in their own territory at the 13-yard line.
Unfortunately, on the mesh there, Robinson a little close, and the ball was extended. Nolan Henderson didn't have an opportunity to what we call chest it, secure it against his body, and that resulted in the play, the ball being on the ground. A good play by Henderson.
Delaware needs 14. They dump it off to Robinson, who would have to run 13 yards from the catch. He didn't come close to the 21-yard line, a gain of 8. They needed 14, and it was Keeling Hunter who made the stop, but that's a tough play to make out of your running back Robinson, catching the ball at the line of scrimmage and asking him to run 13 yards.
Knowing that they're going to be multiple possessions still in this game with 13 minutes to go, I think it was one of those calls you just want to see if you can't break it, and if you can, it's a safe play. Don't turn the ball over deep in your red zone.
Pritchard bounces this one from midfield, takes a Delaware hop to the 40, rolling at the 39-yard line, probably call it the 40, where Villanova will possess it when we come back. 35-21, the Wildcats up by 14, 12:43 to play. Delaware needs something big on the defensive side. Back in a moment.
Are you facing a financial crisis because of nursing home bills? Do you need help staying in your home? The team at Estate and Elder Law Services can help you qualify for Medicaid benefits to cover nursing home costs or care at home and preserve your savings. Located at 2961 Centerville Road, visit Estate and Elder Law Services online at www.eaels.com or call 302-651-0113. That's 302-651-0113.
You don't know because you're in a car, but Arby's three new deep-fried turkey sandwiches are a sensory treat. Imagine what normal turkey smells like, but then better. Imagine what regular turkey tastes like, but then more succulent juiciness. Imagine a sandwich you were gonna eat, but then add you driving to Arby's for a delicious new deep-fried turkey sandwich. Okay, maybe snap out of it. You're still driving. Arby's, we have the meat.
At participating Arby's for a limited time.
You're listening to 94.7 WDSD, celebrating 20 seasons as the home for Blue Hens football.
Acme doesn't want you to miss a single one of life's great moments. That's why Acme offers free flu shots with most insurance. No copayment unless required by your plan. Plus, you'll earn 10% off your next grocery purchase, up to $200 when you get your flu shot at an Acme pharmacy. Some restrictions do apply. Delaware back on offense, back defending as the offensive Villanova on the field. We see Casey Hinton back in the game. He sat last time out for Justice Henley, the true freshman. And it's first and 10, Villanova. Delaware needs some type of turnover or a quick drive by the Wildcats. They'll keep it on the ground, and Kobe Reeder wrestles Justin Covington to the ground. A tackle for loss by Kobe Reeder. His second on the day, fifth on the season.
Kobe Reeder is so active. He's long and explosive. He's overcome that back injury that plagued him in the early spring and then even in the early preseason practice. He is such a tough competitor. Fiery, continues to play hard no matter what the situation is, and it has the ability to make a lot of big plays. Delaware needs one of those from him right now.
Second down and 12 out of shotgun. It's Bednarczyk running wide. Covington, he cuts up the field, has some room. Adderley trips him up as he dives for the first down marker at midfield. I think he got all 12. He did. That's a first down to midfield by Justin Covington, his longest run of the day.
That's the first time Covington's been able to show off his speed as he was working on the right to left quick sweep and showed really good speed there getting to the first down marker.
Fresh set of downs for Villanova from midfield. They've gained 10. Delaware some movement on the defensive line. They get back. Cam Kitchen is hurt. He's out for the day. Justin Covington up the middle this time. Tripped up by Adderley again, but another 8 yards for Covington. 20 yards on back-to-back carries for Covington.
Villanova probing to their left side away from their outstanding tackle and some of their reserves, but a really fine wham blocks initiated there by Ryan Bell, the tight end that had the touchdown pass earlier.
It's a big loss for Delaware defensively with Cam Kitchen sitting on the trainer's table ever since he made that interception that was called back earlier in this half. Here's Forbes. First down and more. 30. Dragging a defender to the 25-yard line. And Nova continues to move the football on offense. Colby Reeder on the stop.
Well, Delaware's got to continue to find different defensive line combinations to get into some of these gaps right now. Villanova has the momentum. They're working downhill. Their offensive line gaining confidence on every play.
See Sal Morrow come into the game. Ashworth and Brandon Hall, the combo this time around, is Nova up to 441 on offense today. Running back to the right of Bednarczyk is Forbes. To the left is Justin Covington. A 35-21 lead for the Wildcats, who have won one other game in CAA football. Covington wrapped up, big loss. Troy Reeder, the senior, trying to make an impact in what will be his final regular season game. Delaware hoping that their season will be extended, but a big loss on first down for Nova.
Covington trying to run the stretch to the right. Troy Reeder ran it terrifically well. Hall was there, as well as Buck Jones, so really good team defense to get Villanova way off track early on. Kind of a questionable call there by Villanova to take a chance to lose that much yardage on first down.
Troy made it happen. Third tackle of the day, 110 tackles on the year for Troy Reeder. Second down and 19. It's Forbes. He's stopped Minimal gain if he did get back to the line of scrimmage. Dre Jones and Sal Morrow with the tackle, and that's another tackle for loss, actually. They'll lose two. Third and 21 coming out. Villanova not in field goal range.
That was a counter play that Villanova's used before they start left and then weave it back quickly right. Sal Morrow not fooled at all. Perfect position.
Nova, third and 21. Trips to the left side. From the Delaware 36-yard line. 9:06 and ticking. Crowd making noise. Forbes to the right of Bednarczyk. He's got 2 seconds to snap the football. Gets it off. Bednarczyk dropping back. Here comes Bell. Bednarczyk lets it fly out of bounds. Nearest man was Jarrett McClinton. And it's fourth and 21.
Excellent pressure, and I love it when Delaware brings those inside linebackers. Very successful blitz patterns. That time Bell looping to the left in perfect position to get in Bednarczyk's face. Really good call there by defensive coordinator and his staff, Chris Koch.
Vinny Papale back to return. Vince Papale in the building today, as is Dick Vermeil and Ron Jaworski also here to watch Vinny and the rest of the Blue Hens. See what Papale can do if he gets a chance, as the punter for Villanova stands at midfield, takes a step, punts it high. Adderley runs up to catch it at the 8-yard line. Delaware will have to go 92 yards to get a touchdown on this drive. We'll take our final timeout with 8:46 remaining in the Wildcats of Villanova, up 14 over Delaware.
This is Annie.
Hi.
Annie thinks she has good oral care.
Yep, I brush every day, twice a day.
But she's actually being a little oral careless.
Wait, what?
See, rinsing with Act Restoring Mouthwash helps you go beyond brushing.
How does it do that?
It actually strengthens your enamel.
Oh, that's good.
And it even protects your teeth from harmful acids.
That's really good, because I love my coffee.
So don't be oral careless, people. Use Act Restoring Mouthwash every day.
I'll be swishing tonight.
Good job, Annie.
Keep moving with Easy Pass.
Hey, UD fans. Tired of waiting in toll cash lines? Well, Easy Pass is the answer. Easy Pass is an electronic toll collection method, making traveling more convenient and quicker as you go through participating toll facilities in the Northeast. Easy Pass helps reduce traffic congestion for everyone. You can get Easy Pass by simply going to ezpassde.com, by calling 1-888-EZ-PASS-DE to open an account, or by visiting any Delaware toll plaza.
Delaware football is on 94.7 WDSD FM and iHeartRadio.
8:46 left to play. Delaware down 35-21. We know our quarterback situation with Pat Kehoe out for the day. Nolan Henderson is the QB, but question marks with the running back situation today. For more on that, to the sideline we go with Corey Nido.
Thanks, Scott. Well, we knew coming into this game that the bruising running back Kenai Kane was banged up. We weren't sure how much we'd see of the senior running back, and it looks like we won't see much of him as Andre Robinson, the transfer from Penn State, back out. Dejon Lee does have his helmet on. He's not injured, but right now Delaware moving forward with Robinson, Scott.
Haven't seen Lee for now 3 possessions in this game. Lee, 98 yards and 2 scores, but he's been out of the ball game since that second touchdown run. And Delaware waiting for the signal. Now they can operate with Andre Robinson, the running back, Henderson, the QB, from their own 8-yard line. Henderson will throw, or looking to do so, back into the end zone, now stepping forward. Going to be a big loss, but no safety as Henderson stepped out of the end zone and got to the 2-yard line. A loss of 6 on first down, and Delaware's offense suddenly going backwards.
Solid coverage downfield by Villanova. Henderson will learn ultimately that's a ball he's got to get out of his hands and throw away. Live to play the next down. Now because the clock runs and you lose yardage. So one of those plays that a young quarterback, it just takes time and the experience to do that. It's much easier said than done.
Mark it at the 3-yard line. Owen Tyler back in as an extra blocker. Some confusion offensively as Henderson shifts Scarf and Owen Tyler. And now there is a whistle on the field.
We have a timeout.
To leave.
Charge to Villanova.
Villanova called the timeout. I think they might have helped out Delaware, as they look like all types of confusion offensively for a Delaware. And Villanova is the team that calls the timeout. Interesting.
I wouldn't have been surprised if it was Delaware burning the timeout there. So a break for the Hens, as they'll have all three timeouts left. Villanova will have two remaining. And just to recap this game, as it's been a wild one, we've had three overturn calls on an interception, a fumble recovery. Those reversed to the way of Villanova. The first play of the game was a reverse call as Nasir Adley tipped the football in the end zone, seemingly went out of the end zone and then back in. It was called a safety on the field. That reversed, and Delaware has lost their quarterback. The ball, even the play was wacky in which he was injured. The ball just slipped out of his hands. It flew into the air, was intercepted by Villanova, and Akio was hit on the play. He's got a concussion. He is out of the game. We've seen J.P. Caruso. We've seen Nolan Henderson. Nolan Henderson was injured. He came back in the game. And Delaware down 35-21. They've lost six in a row to Villanova. Second year in a row, they come in as the favorites with seven wins, trying to get to eight. And Henderson out of his own end zone will throw on second and long. Rushing, trying to get out of the end zone, does so with space at the 15. Jab step at the 10, juke move to the 20. A first down pickup by Nolan Henderson, somehow getting out of traffic and picking up the yards necessary.
Boy, is he amazing, isn't he, Scott? The ability to feel the pressure, step up into the pocket, and then make the decision, hey, I've got to run it, but then where to run it? He's very elusive. He made a defender miss in space with those hips. I've been incredibly impressed with his poise back there, considering the moment, not to mention the fact he's working on a bad ankle.
That's an 18-yard pickup. It gives Delaware some space. Nolan Henderson up to 46 yards rushing. This is his first collegiate football game in the Battle of the Blue, final regular season game. Henderson, pocket, collapses. He's scrambling again, throwing on the run into traffic. Somehow Walker got it in between three white jerseys.
What Joe Walker did there was a veteran play with actually a fairly young receiver in terms of games played. He was in the scramble mode. Walker came all the way across the field to make himself available and then made a terrific catch with several players around. Henderson showed to me his ability and his arm strength there as he threw that ball across his body. It could have been a pick with somebody lesser.
That had Rob Roll pick six written all over it. Instead, it's first and 10 at the Delaware 38-yard line. Henderson again, throwing again. Scarf with the catch at the 41, up to the 45. We'll mark it at the 43 and a half, actually, as he went backwards and was tackled. But some rhythm now for Nolan Henderson and this offense. It went 18-yard run by Henderson, 17-yard catch by Walker, and now a 5-yard pickup. Hens in a hurry as they're running out of time. 6:30 left in the fourth quarter, down two scores, 35-21. Henderson throwing again, far side of the field, almost picked off as Christian Benford ran and knocked the football away. That's his sixth pass breakup of the season, his second of the day.
Well, good arm strength there by Nolan Henderson. That's the only reason that ball wasn't intercepted. Benford did a great job of reading the eyes of Henderson, drove on it, but the ball was out so quickly from Henderson's hand, as he's done his whole career in high school. Very good at that. That avoids the interception.
Clock stopped at 6:20. Delaware down 35-21. Fourth quarter. Hens driving for their potential playoff lives. Henderson out of shotgun. Low snap. Picks it up. Scrambling. Hit. Fumble. Ball is loose. No signal on the field. Villanova came up with the football, and now they signal to the Wildcats. The turnover gives it back to Villanova.
Well, it was a low snap that Henderson, I don't believe, ever had an opportunity to possess, and they were bringing a blitz in from the field, and that's who ultimately created the fumble.
Henderson had to scramble backwards with the football, and as he was hit, Drew Wiley, who had an interception earlier in the game, was able to fall on the football as David Cole was close to the action, trying to hop on, but Wiley gets the fumble and
didn't look to me, Scott, that Nolan ever possessed the ball.
He picked it up.
He picked it up, but I'm not sure. Did he have it enough? And then Wiley comes in and knocks it out.
I mean, it was close. He certainly was not secure in his running backwards, but it was knocked out of his hand. He had to pick it up, and it became a scramble drill from there. Delaware down 14, and perhaps their hopes of ending the losing streak to the Wildcats ending right there as Forbes will run and Narzik and the Villanova offense will continue to just run the football and milk this clock. Down to 6 minutes. And Delaware going to have to put their playoff hopes in the hands of the FCS football playoff committee. down by 14, 5:49. The way this game is going, you just don't think Delaware is, unless something miraculous happens, unless there's a scoop and score, unless there's something that happens really quickly, we might see for the 12th time in 13 games, Villanova beat the Delaware Blueheads.
Well, we'll see Villanova do a great job here with the clock, letting it run down every play. Probably will be in Forbes or Covington.
It's Covington this time, slicing through and picking up a first down to the 11-yard line. 35-21 the score. Covington has done well in his second half. Forbes has 127-yard rush. He had 140 a year ago. And these runners for Villanova have been able to accumulate 180 yards on the ground, 269 through the air. There's been some big chunk plays, big passes by Benarczyk to set up what have been touchdown scores on the ground by Gudzik, Benarczyk, and Forbes twice. 35-21, under 5 minutes to play. Regular season finale. It's Forbes. Makes one man miss and adds to Villanova's total.
Touchdown, Villanova.
4:42 left, and the Wildcats put Delaware away, up 20.
Well, Forbes, as we talked about in the pregame show, a terrific runner, a senior from Newburgh, New York, has really had one of his better games of his career in the big moment. That offensive line, which was remade with injuries for Villanova, certainly gets a lot of kudos for the job they've done here this afternoon.
41-21. Villanova taking advantage of the turnover. Three plays, 30 yards. Took just 91 seconds to get in the end zone. And Aaron Forbes, 24 carries, 138 yards. How about that? He had 140 a year ago. 138 now. Bad snap, but it's collected and put through by Drew Kresge. Stay right here with 4:42. And Bill, we had the conversation at halftime as it looked like there was a possibility of a Villanova coming away victoriously. And we talked about seven wins being a scenario where Delaware still gets in. Six teams would not be unheard of, especially the way this season has gone in FCS football. But I asked the question, do you think the FCS football committee looks at scores? And right now down 21 to a 4-6 Villanova team, at least from a scoring standpoint, if you're looking into the final game and not the overall resume, if you're taking any emphasis on the final game of the year, you gotta wonder.
Got a great Black Friday deal. One for you, one for me.
Aw, I love it. I got us a little something too.
Yeah?
Yep. One for you and one for me.
I love it.
Oh, actually that was supposed to be for me.
I love it.
And I love that you love
it. I love it.
I like red.
During the GMC Sierra Black Friday event, get over $12,000 total value on a specially equipped 2018 Sierra SLT Crew Cab when you finance through GM Financial.
Oh, say can you see?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
The Delaware.
I agree with you there. Colgate losing today, the eighth-ranked team in the country. That's to Army. Elon down by a point to Maine. 4:26 left in that one. It's 27-26. Number 21, San Diego. They beat Marist 31-14. Just looking at some other scores that might impact. ETSU, 19th in the country. They're up 24-17 against Samford with 7:42 left in the third. A lot of football left there. As you see Dejon Lee back in a lineup and fielding a kick return at the 15. 20-yard line, has blockers there, bouncing to the 25, and down he goes at the 26. As we look at some other scores, Wofford, 13th in the country, they should be in up at halftime, 28-14. Dartmouth beating Brown, 13-17 in the second quarter there. Delaware was an early start time, so there'll be a lot of games later on in the day that Delaware will have to pay attention to. Princeton, 11th-ranked team in the country, up in the third, 21-14. over Penn. And some other games will be going on later on today as James Madison up 21-10 over Towson in the second quarter there. Southeast Missouri State up over Illinois, that one in the second quarter. So because of the early start for Delaware, we're not going to be able to get many finals in this game today while it still goes on. Henderson in the offense back out on the field. Henderson eludes some pressure, throws across his body. Papali with a catch, running forward at the 35. Down he goes at the 39-yard line. First down pickup will stop the clock momentarily as they move the chain.
Henderson doing a nice job there of abandoning the pocket at the right moment. Finds Papali working back underneath. Vinny Papali very good after the catch.
Papali's second catch today. Henderson again has to scramble a bit, trying to keep the play alive, but he's sacked by Brian White. White with his first sack of the season, the senior defensive tackle. And these Villanova seniors, they've beaten Delaware four times, unless something changes drastically in the last 4 minutes, which I don't see happening. As we're at 3:53, fourth quarter. Henderson throwing again, no one to throw to again, dancing in the pocket again. Rolling out of the pocket, throwing across his body, and Rob Roll had an interception dropped. There is a flag on the play. Rob Roll had the ball hit him in the number four. That's a preseason FCS All-American who dropped
personal foul.
An INT.
Roughing the passer, number 58 on the defense. It's a 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Jeff Steeb having a bad day. It's a couple penalties on him, and that's a personal foul on the senior.
That was just a terrible play. I was watching Henderson with his elusiveness back there. He's already released the ball. He's taken a step and a half, and then Steve comes in and knocks the young quarterback to the ground. Just not a smart play and kind of a cheap play for a veteran.
If you're just tuning into this one, Delaware 7-3 on the year, trying to get to 8 wins on the year. Their quarterback, Pat Kehoe, knocked out of the game in the second quarter. Nolan Henderson, the backup QB, has played just fine, 8 of 12, 111 yards. But Nova's offense too much as Charles Scarf catches another pass to the 41-yard line in Nova territory. It's going to be second down and 3 as the clock ticks at 3:30, fourth quarter.
Henderson very intelligently on these, not checkdowns per se, because those are usually the running backs, but he's finding Scarf on these low routes, which he makes himself available because of his big frame.
Henderson looking. Throwing ball tipped incomplete, and it was Steve, the senior we just talked about at middle linebacker, getting his hand on that one. Third down and 3:14 to play. Delaware down 42-21.
Well, as an offensive lineman, when you're going to throw a lot of quick passes, these three steps, you've got to be sure that after your first initial contact, you get another quick hit to get the defensive lineman's hands down. That time, unfortunately, that did not happen, and Henderson's pass was knocked down.
Henderson 9 of 14 today, 118 yards through the air. Running back is Robinson. We have not seen Dejon Lee as a running back in the fourth quarter. Trips to the right side for Henderson. They need 3 yards for a first down. In the pocket stands Henderson. He throws near side of the field, coming back to get it. Charles Scarf. His momentum brought him back towards the line of scrimmage. He was trying to reach backwards, essentially, to not fall forward and lose out on what would have been a first down, and he did so. First down yardage to the Villanova 37.
Smart play there by Scarf, who was just extending the ball, as you so well described, to be ensure that he got the first down.
For boys in the game, as Henderson will throw, tossing again to Charles Scarf, keeping it at the 35-yard line. The ball reaching away from a Villanova defender, palming it like a basketball player might, posting up in a game underneath the rim. And he gets to the 34-yard line, second down and 7, and Delaware will start using their timeouts. 2:39 left to go. Delaware down 21 points, and 12 of the last 13 games in this rivalry are going to go to Villanova. And there's been just teams that are better in Delaware for Delaware. I mean, you think of, you know, you go back 13 years and the quarterback for the Baltimore Ravens was the quarterback for the University of Delaware. You go back 13 years and a guy that spent time on the Miami Dolphins, Pat Devlin was the quarterback for the Delaware Blueheads. You've got teams that played for national championships that didn't beat Villanova. And now in the last two regular season finales, last year was 7 wins, a chance to get 8 against a Villanova team that struggled. This year, 7 wins, a chance for 8 against a Villanova team that has struggled. Going to lose, and not a close game either.
Well, it's very difficult, no matter how well your backups play, when your first team quarterback goes down in the early stages of the game. It's very difficult to rebound from, and I would tell you that I think Villanova's offense has been as sharp in a big game as they've been in the entire season.
Yeah, Nolan Henderson has looked good at the quarterback position. So it's really been, you're right, the offense of Villanova that's been too much. Second down, seven passes incomplete, looking for Jamie Jarman. Shame that Jamie didn't get to be more a part of the action today, returning from an injury. I'm sure he was fired up to be back out there with his teammates. No catches today for Jamie Jarman. That's his second target of the contest.
Well, it's great to see Jarman getting back in here as a senior, the terrific athlete from Indian River here in Millsboro, Delaware. A really good young man. He's done a great job, converted from baseball to come back and get his amateur status as a college football player. I really like the path that this young man has taken.
Henderson, a low snap on third down and seven. Open is Walker, catching at the 12, makes a move to get inside the 10-yard line and out of bounds, first and goal to go for the Blue Hens.
Well, really fine throw. Cross the field to a crossing Joe Walker from right to left, avoid in the Villanova zone. A really nice pattern down the field on what we call a sail route, a long route going across the top of the defensive's formation. And a really nice step in by Henderson, who's working off that bad foot.
26 yards on the catch for Joe Walker. Walker up over 100 yards receiving in this game on five catches. First to go to go from the eight. Trips to the right side. Henderson looking to the right. Throwing back of the end zone high and uncatchable for Jamie Jarman, who was covered well. Probably the best spot that Henderson could have put that pass was out of bounds.
Well, that was an experienced play by the young player, Nolan Henderson. As you described, good coverage at the pylon in the back of the right end zone. The sun was bearing down. Why force it in on first down? Throws it out of bounds. Live to play another play. And stop the clock.
And I'd say this is an impressive showing by Nolan Henderson, who's playing for the first time as a collegiate athlete in front of a large crowd, in front of a crowd watching a rivalry football game. And now Henderson takes the second down snap from the 8-yard line. In the pocket, now scrambling, throwing high for Jamie Jarman. If it was on point, it probably would have been a score, but incomplete went the pass. And now it's third down and eight. 2 minutes left, 1:55 on the clock as it stopped here in the fourth.
Well, I think it's important that Delaware understands how well Villanova has played here this afternoon and how difficult it is in these big games if you don't have all your players available. And we've had some injuries, a hard-hitting affair. But I like the way Delaware has continued to compete. Henderson has certainly done everything he can within his power to make this game as close as it can be.
It's 42-21. It's just been Villanova offense. It just looks sharp. They look like the team to beat Temple the first week of the season. Henderson looking, flushed out of the pocket. Here comes contact. The flag is going to be thrown. Might be holding against Delaware as the sack was made by Joseph Sotomayor.
Holding, number 78 on the offense.
It is holding. Just trying to help out his quarterback was Jethro Pepe, who missed part of 17 with ACL injury. Actually, he came back in time for the Villanova game last year to Jethro Pepe and called for the hold there. He was just trying to help out his QB.
You get caught sometimes on the scramble. Your hands are inside the frame. The defender starts to work outside, and that hand just naturally slides that way and created the hole. And it's an easy call because the official who's responsible for the quarterback, the referee, is just trailing that and is going to see exactly where the offensive lineman's hands go.
Timeout coming from Delaware to get their offense in order. 98 seconds left in this contest. Touchdown is what Delaware needs on fourth down here from the 19-yard line. We remind our listeners that Excel Business Systems is the official business system partner of the Blue Hens Radio and iHeartRadio Delaware. Excel Business Systems has been in business since 1984 with two office locations serving the entire Delaware Valley. Excel offers unsurpassed sales, service, and supplies. They are also an authorized sales and service provider for hardware and software solutions. For more, visit exceldigital.com. Delaware is just going to have to wait and see. Tomorrow, I believe at 12:30, is the committee selection show. They would have loved to pick up that eighth win of the year, but instead they'll put it in the hands of a committee to decide whether they make the playoffs for the first time since 2010. See if Nolan Henderson, who came in for an injured Pat Kehoe, got injured himself. J.P. Caruso came into the game, and now it's Henderson. After the timeout by Delaware, Hens will have one more timeout, but won't possess the football again unless they Well, they'll need to score a touchdown here either way. Nolan Henderson on fourth and goal from the 19. That's going to end the game. Ball comes loose. It's still batted around. And I believe Villanova came up with it either way. We're going to turn over on downs as it was fourth and 19.
Well, the pocket collapsed. Henderson was trying to escape it up to make a throw into the end zone, and he just had no opportunity. A really good stand by Villanova under pressure. More importantly, as you mentioned several times, the offense has been outstanding for Villanova, just possessing the ball, being able to put a lot of points on the board. And I credit the reemergence of the quarterback, Benarczyk, who really did an excellent job, along with Forbes and others, and Hall, certainly one of his Bell, his favorite receiver, had an excellent afternoon as well.
And Nolan Henderson is 175 pounds. He just has not been hit by physical players like this in his career. It's his first game. He's not gotten hit like that. His last two possessions, he's fumbled the football with hits by big defenders by the Villanova Wildcats. And now with 127 left, the Wildcats can just run this clock out. Deller only has one timeout left, so a first down will end it. 42-21 as Delaware uses their final timeout after the run by Matt Goodzik to the 22-yard line. 1 minute, 18 seconds remaining. We'll talk about this in the American Spirit Federal Credit Union postgame show. Benny Pinella, he'll have all the scores and highlights from throughout the game. It was just an odd game to start. It began with Nasir Adderley back to return for the first time this season. The ball was knocked out of his hands and on a kind of a squibbish type of kick. It went into the end zone. A safety was called. It was reversed. Delaware then marched down the field as they possessed it after it was overturned. Went 75 yards, went up 7-0, stopped Villanova, got the football back, punted in plus territory, and then Villanova on third down. They go 81 yards. They scored a tie. Villanova takes advantage of a interception thrown by Pat Kehoe, and the interception was not the worst part of that play, it turns out. Pat Kehoe was injured, concussed on the play, did not return, and from there, just a wild football game, including call reversals on interceptions, and just big-time offense by Villanova. Zach Bednarczyk, he started his career against Delaware with a win. He's going to end his career against Delaware with a win. 269 yards passing for Zach Bednarczyk, and a knee going to be taken. They'll have to do it one more time as the backup quarter, Kadir Ismail, the future quarterback for this Villanova team, 6'7", 215. His father standing proud to our right, a broadcaster for the television broadcast. And Kadir Ismail, the future for Villanova as the clock winds down. Ismail saying to me, his father played for the Baltimore Ravens and won a Super Bowl with the Ravens, a wide receiver. And he's got his cell phone out. He is he's filming this from up top. A proud moment for the Ismail family as he'll take one final knee. But
quarterback Kadir Ismail.
Delaware falls for the seventh time in a row to the Villanova Wildcats as the final knee makes it official. Villanova has won now 12 of the last 13 games against the Blue Hens. Danny Rocco, Mark Ferrante will shake hands at the 40-yard line, have a conversation, and Danny Rocco will talk with Corey Nido after a tough loss. And now Delaware just has to hope that the FCS football committee thinks that they did enough this season to continue their season. A loss on senior day for the Blue Hens as the Villanova players and Delaware players shake hands in the middle of the field. The final today, 42-21. Villanova the winners. And they just have Delaware's number. You know, we talk about the final, the last 12 games, not having anything to do with this one. And this one as an individual game was bizarre, just like many of the other games have been against Delaware and Villanova, as Pat Kehoe gets knocked out, Cam Kishin gets knocked out of the game for Delaware. That's two of their stars. And Villanova was able to run the football well. They were able to score. They were able to answer every time Delaware scored. And the Wildcats played a better football game today as Delaware was banged up and had to go with their backup